sweat and tears. I conquered my fears. I'm ready to fly now. We know they scared of us. No, they don't care for us. They wasn't there for us. Up in them trenches, hopping them fences, making the plays while they riding the benches. Yeah, got cool intentions. Yeah, I see my goal and get cold in December. When counting our sins, I don't have no friends. I came here to win. My start is your end. Now let it begin now.
Welcome, everybody, to the Fortnite Pro-Am! This is going to be such an incredible event, and I'm so excited that so many of you are joining us here live and in person and online. Joining me today, I have some incredible casters for this event. First up, let me introduce you to our esports commentator, Golden Boy!
What's up, LA? I need some noise. Give me some noise. Let's go. Come on, come on! That's what I like, baby. That's what I like.
Next up, we've got YouTube content creator, Gloom.
Woo! Hi, guys. Oh, I'm so excited.
This is going to be so great. And last but not least, we've got the Twitch broadcaster, Dr. Lupo.
What's going on?
This event today is going to be so much fun, and I'm so glad that we're all here for it.
I can't believe it. Look at this crowd. Unbelievable. Are you kidding me? This is unreal stuff, guys.
I don't think any of us expected it to be this big. It's insane.
There's a whole lot of people here, which means opportunities to make some changes. Like, I can no longer be just Ninja's friend, I think. Maybe. We'll see.
We have so many things lined up for you guys. To get you guys all hyped and give you a look at what we've got coming up, we've got a little clip for you. Check it out.
We're here in Los Angeles, where you're about to witness some of the biggest names in gaming and entertainment drop into the brand new Bank of California Stadium. They will compete for bragging rights and a part of a $3 million prize pool that will go to the charity of their choice. We've assembled some of the best gamers, streamers, and competitive players around, along with some of the biggest names in entertainment. They will join forces as duos and compete for that sweet, sweet victory royale. The rules are simple, 50 duos. One player from the world of gaming and one from entertainment. They drop in, build, and battle until only one duo remains. The stage is set, the players are ready, and in Fortnite, anything can happen. Who will rise up and who will fall? The world is watching. Welcome to the Fortnite Celebrity Pro-Am at E3 2018.
This is going to be so great, and the best part about it is this is all for charity.
We have a $3 million prize pool today.
That's right. And what, you know, I think honestly, what I want to see, crazy rocket rides. I want to see some shopping cart plays. I just want to see shenanigans, Lupo.
Impulse nades, Tim taking fall damage, all the things that you've seen in every Fortnite video you've watched online. It needs to happen today.
That's right.
For sure. And anything can happen. We're going to be tossing it up to Zeke, who is with some players who are preparing for this event. So let's see who he's got for us.
Hey guys, Zeke here, and I'm down at the Field Club. We're going to be talking to some of our pro gamers and even some of our celebrities. And I'm going to be asking them a few questions. See where they'd like to land, maybe their favorite weapon. Maybe I'll get them to dance for me. So let's find out.
Where's your favorite place to land and why?
I love Fatal Fields and Anarchy Acres. I don't know why. I love, like, the farms. Usually because, like, there's a lot of flat land. You get to see your opponents and be prepared.
Yeah. Do you have a favorite gun and why?
Legendary Scar. It just feels like you're actually lasering people when you hit them. It's great.
Where do you like to land in Fortnite?
As far away from other people as possible.
Right now, I'm really loving the crater outside to the west of Pleasant Park. That's where I'm gonna be. I think I'm going to be landing in today's match. I've got all the strategies already flowing around in my head. I've been thinking about this a lot.
Favorite gun in Fortnite has to be Golden Grenade Launcher. Oh my God, it's devastating. I mean, wherever you shoot that thing, building doesn't matter. Everything gets destroyed, including every player on the map.
So why Bright Bomber?
Why Bright Bomber? That's a silly question. Bright Bomber is hilarious. Look at it. Look at his face. No, I love it. It's a really colorful, fun costume. I think that kind of sums up Fortnite a bit. It doesn't take itself too seriously, but it's so much fun. And this costume sort of portrays how fun it could be. So.
All right, my favorite emote, the most disrespectful. Take the L.
Perfect, dude. There you go.
All right, so we're back here over at the booth. Welcome, everyone. How you doing today? You feeling good? Feeling a little toasty?
It's a little warm.
It's a little warm
hydrated
today.
All right, Dad said so.
That's right. So, I mean, you can see it in my face as well. I'm a little sweaty, you know, but it's all right, though. It ain't an outside broadcast.
You look fantastic.
Thank you so much, Lupo. I really appreciate it. You really are more than just Ninja's friend, buddy. You really are.
We'll see if I can get to that point today.
Okay, so here's the thing, right? We're here. It's a Fortnite Pro-Am, and Fortnite is such a unique game. Guys, it's such a unique game. It brings so many different tools and different opportunities to the table. And I think, you know, we would kind of be remiss not to mention the building, the number one thing that makes Fortnite so unique. And, I mean, God, you've been playing for such a long time, and you've seen some incredible plays in your time.
But, I mean, even just looking here at Ninja, the opportunity to outbuild opponents, when it arises, this is the kind of guy that shows up every single time. And his building's on point. He's putting boxes on people. He's jump shotgunning like an absolute savage. And you see here, they might have been mobile players. You have no idea, but he's just putting them to shame. Yeah. The building is amazing, and it's such a pivotal part of Fortnite over a lot of other games that I've played, and I think that's part of what has had me at least hooked in a big way.
But then there's also the crazy moments as well, Cassie.
Unpredictability. You can use impulse nades and...
That's filthy.
Her line of sights are filthy. She sets it up. She still has those first-person shooter mechanics. Nasty snipe. One-shot girl is unbelievable.
Crazy. Yeah, I mean, honestly, we're going to see some amazing plays today. We keep saying that, but, I mean, the players that we have that are going to come out in just a little bit are some of the best in the game, and they're going to be joined by a lot of celebrities who actually play the game. Every celebrity here plays the game. I mean, it makes sense. Fortnite is the most popular game in the world, so, you know. Makes sense that you would want to be in that position here at the Pro-Am, right, Lupo?
I think it kind of shows the way that Fortnite has just grown into this astronomical, this phenomenon almost. I can't recall any other game that's done this kind of growth at this rate in this way and been fun the entire time.
That's right. So now we want to kind of run through how the competition is going to work. Okay, because there are going to be three matches played today. And the first matchup is going to be a solos matchup. And the second will be a duos matchup, followed by the big charity cash matchup. $3 million up for grabs for charity. $1 million going to first place, Cassie.
I'm really excited for this first match, like to see how everybody actually matches up in solos.
Yeah, I mean, it's going to be insane to see, you know, not only some of the best players in the world clash against one another, but doing it for their charity as well, Lupo.
It's big. So solos, that warm-up situation, you know, the opportunity to kind of get used to the game, used to the environment that we're in is a little different maybe than what some of these players are used to playing in. So, settling in for the first game. Duos right after that so we can get a little bit of teamwork going, you know, try and plan your drops, that kind of thing. And then the big one.
That's right.
Match number three.
One. The big match that we're all here for. I'm so excited. But for now, though, let's actually send it over to Justine, who's over at one of my favorite areas on the stage, the Llama Lounge.
This is the Llama Lounge. So there's going to be a lot going down here today. So as people are playing, they're going to come over here. We're going to have a chat with them, see what went wrong or what potentially went right. But we've got a chat with Mooney, who has been talking to some of our players in the plaza. So let's see what he's got for us.
What's up, guys? Mooney here at the Fortnite Pro-Am 2018. For all of you at home, let's head to the plaza and check out what's going on. Every one of the entrants gets one of these bags. Let's take a look at what's inside. A little foam pickaxe off the bat here. Get a visor, keep those sun rays out of your eyes. And every one of you, as you enter the venue, you're gonna get one of these sunglasses because you know we're California. Need to keep those rays out. It's a beautiful sunny day. So we also brought in a physical battle bus. You may have seen the inflatable one kind of floating around LA. We got a physical one here, ready to board and ready for folks to drop in to the Fortnite Pro-Am. We got the ice cream truck from the game. All vanilla, either get some purple ice cream or some black ice cream. With my sweet tooth, I'll probably enjoy either. Hey, you guys all excited for the Pro-Am?
There really is so much going on, but what it all comes down to is the players, and I'm sure that's what you guys are all here for. So let's take a look at who we have competing here. These are 50 of our streamers. Let's check it out.
The Fortnite Celebrity Pro-Am is bringing together the biggest names in gaming. Tonight, the personalities you know and love will meet face to face to prove who's got what it takes to earn the ultimate victory royale. The winning duo will nab part of that $3 million prize pool for the charity of their choice. Now let's take a look at some of the big names that you'll see drop it from the battle bus. What can you say about Ninja that hasn't already been said?
Boom! You're a monster!
Not only was Myth one of the first streamers to embrace Fortnite Battle Royale, he was also the first Fortnite player picked up by TSM.
First, we're gonna kill Ninja and Myth. Get them out of the way.
I don't like that. I'm sorry.
Bolito is making a name for himself.
Sin ti no soy nada.
Don't sleep on Kinstar. He'll do whatever it takes. The list of talent goes on and on. Ali A, Pokimane, Nick Merckx, Gotaga, CDN the Third. He's one of the most charismatic entertainers.
So you better be careful.
Watch out for me building high with Ty.
Also joining us today, Sniper Wolf, Cypher PK, King Richard, and many more. 50 gamers, 50 entertainers, one victory royale. Who will take home a portion of $3 million for the charity of their choice? Who will get the golden pickaxe? It's time to find out. This is the Fortnite Celebrity Pro-Am.
There you have it. I mean, just it's a who's who of
I'm
talent
so
here. I can't wait for everyone to come out. It's actually going
to
be so ridiculous. But before we do that, though, we actually want to thank the people who are supporting this event. Of course, you have HP, Omen. You also have Sony, Microsoft, Logitech G, Astro, as well as AK Racing for supplying the great hardware and chairs that we're going to be playing on today. Lots of good stuff, folks. But, you know, I think the other thing that we do need to discuss here is, it kind of touched on in the video, right? All the players are going to be coming from all across the world to compete here on this stage. I mean, like I said before, a who's who of individuals. And I think we would be lying to ourselves if we didn't have to mention this guy, but we have to. It's, of course, Ninja, the one and only.
Who's
Ninja?
Anybody in the crowd heard of Ninja before?
I don't know if they have. And Ninja, I mean, one of the most well-known, if not the most well-known, Fortnite player that's out there today. I mean, this guy, his skill in the game, it's unprecedented.
Terrifying, honestly, to go up against. I've only run into him one time, but I've seen plenty of people who have had the sad moment of doing so. And look at the
minigun
right here.
Gun play.
The minigun is ridiculous for a player like him. He could literally use any gun, and it's lethal.
Yeah, it's just, again, I remember when he put together that crazy, was it like 24 elimination game before? He did that all with the LMG. Like,
dude, if he can hear you right now, you're just growing.
I'm just gassing.
You know that, right?
I'm just gassing, it's
making it worse and worse right now. And you also have players like Kinstar, I mean, that take advantage of the height advantage. Look at this guy. He's just bombing. Impulse nades in, trying to mix it up a little bit, and he's going to tap fire away at his opponent, who apparently has no idea that he's there. But that top-down view, the elevation is extremely important in Fortnite because you have the building, you have a height advantage, and sometimes players just don't even bother to look up.
No, you don't. And I don't understand why, because elevation is one of the most important things in Fortnite. You have to be able to control the pace of the game like that. Kinstar, very good at that. Gotaga, another player who I'm very familiar with, and this is what I was talking about before, Cassie. Everyone's coming from all across the world here to compete on this stage. Gotaga, one of those individuals coming from France.
So many of these players from all over the world, from Spain, France, Korea, and I'm really excited to see how they do, especially in this new meta.
Yeah, it's very true. I mean, we could dive into that one.
Do we have 3 hours to talk about the meta changes? I don't think so. But like you're saying, we have a big range of players, a ton of different play styles.
Nick Merckx right here sneaking around.
Literally about to sneak up. Look at this guy. Boom. I want to know where these players are when I queue up, man. Come on.
Yeah, and the other thing, too, that I think is something interesting to point out is that players are actually going to be using whatever input decision or whatever input they want, I should say, excuse me. So they would be using whether it's an Xbox controller, a PlayStation controller, a keyboard or mouse. That revolver shot was crazy. And Nick Merckx, one of the most well-known players on console, plays with a PlayStation controller.
I know. You'd think maybe he'd be at a disadvantage, but I've seen this guy in other events, obviously, taunting a little bit of laughter there. It's okay. Nick, bring it down. You bring it down.
Yeah, no,
okay.
Nick, I've known this guy for years. He doesn't bring it down.
It's
going to be crazy. There's a lot of intensity that he's going to be displaying there. The MFAM, I'm sure, will be coming out in full force. But for now, though, we're going to send it over to Zeke, who has some more familiar faces that we get to speak to.
What's your favorite place to land and why?
I got to say, Retail Row. It's my home and native land. Go there every time I have the opportunity, I will drop Retail a million times. So Retail, definitely. You should be dropping there too.
Do you have a favorite weapon and why?
I would say my favorite weapon, I love the grenade launcher. It's because it's so it's so easy. Like, you just spam it out, and then whoop, the whole building goes down, and it's, you know, easy elim. So, yeah, grenade launcher, definitely one of my favorites. The double grenade launcher, you switch, that's a way to, that's one way to scare your opponent.
My favorite gun, I have to go with the blue pump. I mean, you're dealing the most damage, and for me, that's everything that I need, just double pumping all day.
What's your favorite emote, and can you do it for me now?
Favorite emote? I definitely can't do it for you right now. What do I use? Oh, I love the disco. That's absolutely my favorite, 100%.
Favorite weapon is probably the SCAR, just because of its efficiency. You can shoot people all the way across the map. You can use it like a shotgun. I mean, it bangs. It's so accurate. And then with the console auto aim, it also helps my case. So, yeah.
Where's your favorite place to land and why?
Tilted Towers. A lot of action, a lot of fun, a lot of loot.
What's your favorite gun to use and why?
Bolt action sniper rifle. One shot.
Wow. Yeah. I mean, okay, I do have to.
You notice none of them said Tomato Town.
None right, of them. Everybody I'm actually disappointed. None of them said Fatal Fields. I'm
but
just.
Get out of here.
Anyone? Any Fatal Fields people in the house?
Yeah.
Fatal Fields?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Good.
Yeah.
Good.
They make good decisions. And someone else who makes good decisions is Justine. Let's send it over to her right now.
Thanks, Golden Boy. Always about the good decisions. And I think the best decision that they made here was bringing this incredibly massive llama. Like, this is the best. So you guys have met our streamers. You all know them. And in our eyes, they are celebrities. But let's take a look at our traditional celebrities who are being paired up with our gamers.
Since release last year, the Fortnite community has grown by epic proportions. Now everyone from entertainers to athletes are grabbing controllers and asking, where are we dropping? With the Fortnite Celebrity Pro-Am, you're witnessing an incredible mashup. Celebrities joining up with the game's most notable players to compete in our first ever charity event, featuring Marshmello. After he's done performing across the world, he still finds time to build toward his next victory royale. He's forming a duo with his buddy Ninja. Will they be unstoppable?
You build up, I'm shooting everything down.
From the soup to the hit show Community and back to, well, almost the soup, it's Netflix's The Joel McHale Show with Joel McHale. What antics will his teammate Markiplier and him get into? Also joining us, Pete Wentz of Fall Out Boy, MMA fighter Tyron Woodley, actress and singer Jordan Jones, DJ producer Dylan Francis, comedian Ron Funches. He is a lifelong gamer with a passion and a smile that will be hard to match. And watch out for NBA star Paul George, who strives for greatness on the court and is paired up with the renowned builder, Myth. Who is going to get the victory royale with these matchups? Demetrius Johnson, Designer, JT Brown, Reggie Jackson, Madeline Bailey, and so many more.
Everybody get ready to shoot!
Bang, bang.
We'll see how it goes.
You're going down.
It's time to drop. Let's go.
So many people are about to take this stage in a little bit. So, yes, they talked about the players, but I want to talk about the pairings. We have
Absolutely.
Some very unique pairings, and this first pairing is probably my favorite pairing of them all. It is actually going to be CDN III and WWE's very own, from the power of positivity, Xavier Woods. I am so excited. I'm a huge wrestling fan, so for me, this is particularly exciting. And this is going to be a very interesting pair. I mean, I know both of these guys very well, but I think one thing that we're going to get out of this group is a bunch of laughs.
Oh, absolutely. C's a big fan of Dusty Depot now, Dusty Divot. And
right.
If you watch him online at all, can I get a yeet from the crowd here, please?
Yeet!
There you go.
Couple heard us. And then, moving on from that, though, we have Markiplier and actor-comedian Joel McHale.
Markiplier is here for charity. He's been practicing. He rages a lot. He tries to frag. Doesn't quite make it. But you know what? When it comes to charity, he's going to come out here, and he's going to try his best.
Yeah, maybe he can channel that rage and, into the game.
I certainly hope so.
And then the pair that I think could potentially take it all is Cypher PK and Tariq Cohen. This is a dominating team here, Lupo. They have a lot of talent.
Tariq Cohen is scary good at the game. And if you've ever seen Cypher, the self-proclaimed trap god of Fortnite, he has done some really scary things that, honestly, if it happened to me, what he's done to some of those players, I would just uninstall. I'd just be done. That's it. It's over. My career is done.
Yeah, honestly, like I wouldn't even know like how to deal with that. And we've seen some crazy moments early when we were doing our rehearsal. So if it's anything like that, this is going to be a good day indeed. But for now, though, I believe we actually have Zeke, who has some of our more celebrities. And actually, I was double checking on that. We are going to be taking I think we're going to Matt, real fast. I don't know where we're going. We're going somewhere. We're going to the map. There you go. Okay, there, so there you have it. My bad, people. Here you have it. I'm allowed at least one mulligan this whole day. You know what I mean?
So you're looking at the map right now. Where? What's your home in native?
I said it before. I'll say it again. Fatal Fields, baby. That's where it's at.
You don't seem like a farm boy to me. Just saying.
No, not at all. Not at all. But Fatal Fields is the spot to go to. What about for you, Cass?
You know, I'm really interested if there's going to be some reverse psychology today. I feel like everyone's going to want to go to the outside, but they're going to figure, well, maybe everyone's going to the outside. Maybe we should go Tilted. Is Tilted going to be empty or full? That's the question.
Here's my words to all those people that dropped to the outside of the map, okay? Pick up your sticks. I'll see you in Tilted Towers or Retail Row. Aggressive,
really?
or we can't talk, honestly.
Yeah.
Who here plays aggressive? Come on. You know you got to.
Everyone.
That's
pushes.
What's up.
Everyone
That's what's
pushes.
Up.
Unbelievable. You know, you're just
these are my people.
Yeah, I know.
These are my people. You can't deny that.
You're just bathing in the glory of this.
It feels good.
It's ridiculous. But you know what? We also have Zeke over at the Field Club right now, who actually spoke to some of our other celebrities to get their thoughts on this upcoming game.
What's your favorite emote, and can you do it for me now?
Favorite emote is probably Best Meats. Shout out to my best mate, Eradicate.
What's your favorite weapon to use and why?
The pickaxe, because if you get a kill with that, it's just really humiliating.
Do you have a favorite memory from Fortnite?
I almost won a game once, so I'm excited to see if we can maybe replicate that feeling in this tournament.
I have nightmares, by the way, from Fortnite. I wake up every night where I think that I have to shoot something or build somewhere. And I just hear that noise of the blue cloud coming in. Yeah.
Do you have a favorite emote, and can you do it for me now?
I can't do it because it's the one where it's like the guy going like flips and then he
drops down on the floor and does that.
I mean, it worked.
Do you have a favorite emote, and can you do it for me now?
Oh, probably the dab. And all right, let's just there we go. Had to do it on him. Had to do it. You asked for it. You know what I mean?
All right, well, this is an announcement that I'm extremely excited about. Some of you may already be well aware of what you're about to see, but if you're not, here is a very special announcement from Epic. Let's check it out. Well, guys, it is almost time. Are you guys ready? Let's give it up for our players at this year's Fortnite Pro-AM. Come on in, guys.
And what in... That's what we were waiting for? That's what we were waiting for this whole time?
CDN the third.
Held up the line for this.
All the way in, man.
The New Day's passing out pancakes. They're throwing out pancakes. Oh, my goodness gracious. All we need is some booty-os.
This is what I expect from CDN.
CDN is a big man. How tall is that structure that they formed together?
Is Xavier Woods holding CDN on his...
That structure you're talking about is Xavier Woods underneath him. Just so everybody's aware, that's not a building or something.
That's a human being.
That is a person.
And I almost feel like it's unfair that CDN wasn't carrying Xavier Woods.
I should have been the other way around.
Oh, my goodness. And here come all the players.
Got Nate shot in his group.
Coming in.
Got Pokimane. I see her little head poking out there.
What? Some Funk Ops dropping some moves on the floor.
This is so absurd. And everyone's just going in, taking pictures, having a good time. They're starting to make their way up to the stage right now.
Does a bit of this surprise you? Because it doesn't surprise me in the slightest.
Oh, no. I mean,
shenanigans, man. This is shenanigans.
I'm not. Listen, I've worked with Xavier Woods before.
There it is.
The guy's a ridiculous human being.
The dab.
We all signed up for shenanigans today.
We did. It's a lot of dancing.
I'm extremely jealous of the dance moves, to be honest with you. I can't possibly do any of these.
There you can see Myth. He's going to be teaming with NBA professional athlete Paul George. You also got Darkness429 playing with Marcus Scribner. Some good players in this first one. Nate shot as well. This guy's been in the scene for such a long time, and now they're going to start taking the stage. I mean, look at this. All the skins. Everything's out there. This is insane.
Golden Boy, why didn't you dress up as the Tomato Head?
Have you seen me sweat? I don't think it would be a good decision.
Joel McHale coming on in with Joel McHale. Really excited to see those two here.
This is wave number
two.
Valkyrie coming in. There are so many names here.
Yeah.
Can you believe this?
It's
a little bit overwhelming.
It really is, you know. But I think that's what makes this so amazing. Right, and honestly, I wouldn't have it any other way, but I still can't get over the ridiculous
skids. I love it.
They have to play. It's hot up here. They have to play in that outfit.
I'm going to have to talk to that young lady about her slurp juice jug.
El Rubius.
There in a bit.
El Rubius in from Spain. Really excited to see him play. He's a very patient player.
Wow. Just the fans are going absolutely nuts for this as well. Jericho. I don't understand what him and Dylan Francis are doing, but
love the outfit.
Listen, they have a bond that you might be jealous of. Okay, don't make it public. Making a scene.
I know. I am a little salty.
Cypher PK coming in.
Oh boy, he's like one of the favorites in my mind.
Saying before, the trap legend, man, you got to look out for him. And even if he's not there, you still have to look out for what he's left behind, because it might do 150 damage to you, and then you're gone.
Because it just might eliminate you.
You're done.
Cypher's partner, Tariq, is said to be the best Fortnite player in the NFL.
I hope
it's a bold claim.
If he heard that, the ego's going, I'm just kidding. I'm sure he's fantastic.
Yeah, I'm sure he's great. Oh, my goodness. This is so cool. So everyone's starting to make their way out. We're going to have our next wave in just a little bit. And how ridiculous is the pandemonium of everyone coming in?
Look at Cypher's face. You can tell he's feeling it. Joel's getting some pictures of the crowd out there. And the crowd's got to put on a good show for these people, okay? Make some noise.
That's right.
There we go.
Got to get hyped up. Can't you, Sean? There. Oh, there's my boy, Courage. Saw Go Glove, Big Star.
So glad Courage is playing today. His skill has gone up so much in the past few months. It's insane.
Insane indeed. And the Raptor, okay. So we just got all the outfits. Everything's coming out.
I'm telling you, every skin might be here. Chandler Riggs, The Walking
Dead. Maybe a little Skull Trooper, make people a little salty. I don't know.
Oh, dude. Wait. So if they come dressed as a Skull Trooper and it's after it's been released, they technically earned it, right?
Technically.
Uh-oh. Well, fans, now you know how to get it. You just have to dress up like it.
Yeah, that's it. That's as close as you're possibly going to get to this. At least for the time being. But, man, this is and I think this is our last wave.
It's
our
incredible
last wave coming
seeing
through.
All these people come in. Yeah, all these names, all these people from so many different branches of pop culture combined with all the content creators that are here playing today. That's a lot of people, man. That's a lot of people from all over. It's incredible. Marshmallow. Who's this guy with the
final wave?
This guy with the hair. What's that? What's the deal there? I feel like he's gonna go Super Saiyan as he's walking up, right?
Final wave. It's the one and only Ninja and Marshmallow making their way out, alongside with Gotaga, Demetrius Johnson, UFC fighter. We got Samara Redway along with Cyrus Spencer. I mean, so many people. Tim the Tap Man, your buddy, your buddy's here.
I love Tim. You know, it's funny. You mentioned Tim and Ninja was just there. They have very similar play styles, you know?
Yeah.
Both of them very movement-oriented. Ninja likes to make some plays with impulse nades and launch pads and all that kind of stuff. And Tim's movement-based gameplay is very downward, the ground.
Yeah.
I feel like they're basically the same player, you know?
Yeah, essentially, you know? They just basically use gravity to their advantages.
Exactly.
Or disadvantages, depending on who it may be. What?
It just doesn't stop.
There's Femstep.
There's Tim the Tap Man.
There he is. There's Tim. Oh, okay, so question here. Is Marshmallow actually going to play with a hat on? With the helm?
Golden Boy, you realize that's not a hat, right?
That's
his real head.
Oh, yeah, I didn't know that.
You can't remove that.
That's okay. Well, let's hope that the Astros fit it. I mean, it's going to be rather ambitious.
I commend him for it. Hats off to you, sir.
Oh, my goodness gracious. This is just madness. But I think everyone is on their feet, excited, ready to go in a little bit.
Now, if you had to choose one skin to dress up as for an event like this, Golden Boy, what would you pick? What would you come as?
Okay, if I had to pick one, oh boy. I don't know, man.
Reaper would be a very
Reaper would be nice. Reaper I think would be elegant.
If you wanted to frustrate
But I don't have
people,
hair.
Gold
I don't
Reaper.
Have hair. You know, like That's, I'm
you,
you I am
need the flowing mane.
Yeah, I'm yeah. I'm, you know, hair deprived. So
it all migrated down onto your face. It's okay. You look
yeah.
great.
Okay. I know what you're going to say, but what about you?
I'm a Circuit Breaker fan, man. Looking like a cyborg, got to do it.
Yeah. So, okay, you know, the trademark Circuit Breaker. I respect that. We got that Raven one must be pretty. Boiling.
I
don't envy you, sir.
Inside, exactly.
I do not envy you. Oh, man. And they got all the pickaxes, too.
The dance moves coming out. You think you can make a pizza for me right now?
I mean,
or at least
would you want it
deliver
right now?
Hey, I'll eat anytime, man.
Yeah?
If the toppings are right, okay? Oh. Not pineapple. Listen.
Yeah, no. Listen. Pineapple's not the way to go. Anyone who eats pineapple pizza, you are actually a
If you like pineapple
person.
On pizza, it's okay. It's okay to be wrong, all right?
Exactly.
I accept
exactly.
you.
God, we really are just two-piece.
Are we burning our careers to the ground by mentioning that?
There are a lot of – I mean, I'm from New York, so, you know, I mean, if you're coming to me with some pineapple pizza, you know, I mean, that's just – I mean, come on.
Get out of my face.
Get out of my face.
I don't want to talk to you about it.
You know, I ain't having it. See these hands. You know, that's all. That's it. But we also have Justine who's going to be standing by in a little bit. With some of our celebrities there to get their thoughts. And
do you think she will have a conversation with the giant llama?
I want her to have a conversation with the giant llama. We also have Gloom standing by with Myth and Pokimane. Okay, look at that unison. You like that unison?
Mm-hmm.
All right. Well, I think for now, let's send it over to Justine, who has some of our guests on hand.
Oh, we do. But first, we need to welcome all of our players who are up here competing for charity. Are you guys excited for this?
Make some noise.
Let's Woo. Make some noise.
Make it.
Well, let's get this started very, very shortly. I'm so excited for you guys to see what we have in store for you. And let's head it back to the casters.
All right. So Justine in just a little bit is going to
speak. Prepping.
They're prepping, you know, because listen, let's be honest here, okay? There's just a lot of craziness.
I expect an interview with the Tomato Man at a minimum.
I would be disappointed if we didn't get that, because also I just want to ask, like, is it 1,000 degrees inside?
It probably
of
is. It probably is.
Or maybe the tomato is his head, like Marshmallow.
I feel like that's probably experiment related. We probably can't talk about that.
That's true.
The FBI, don't worry about it.
Don't want to mention that stuff. You know, that'd be bad. But, you know, I mean, again, just the sheer pandemonium of the moment, everyone coming up on this stage.
It's
like
incredible.
That.
Look at the crowd, man.
Yeah.
And the
you see
Fortnite?
The Fortnite thing is so sick.
Do you think – can I get that from my house? Can we just move that?
You want all of that in your house?
Yes. Just take the whole thing. Well, yeah. I'll find space. Okay.
Yeah. Okay.
Just I'll put it on the street. It's fine.
I mean, I think your wife's not going to be very happy with that. But
Sorry.
For now,
Sorry,
let's
Samantha.
Send it over to Justine, who has some of our players standing by.
Oh, we've got some of our players here. We've got Prince Royce and Joel McHale. How's it going,
yeah,
guys?
Yeah.
Yeah, hi, Royce. How are you?
I'm doing great. How you doing?
How is the incredibly sweaty two-thirds of the audience doing?
Seems like they're sweating.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's pretty incredible. But, I mean, this is such a crazy event. I mean, have you guys experienced anything like this before in this sort of entirety?
I did this last night here, but no, this is amazing. There's 60,000 people here. It's amazing.
So, I mean, the future of video games, did you ever think growing up, because I was very young, this is something that I never pictured any of us ever experiencing.
When I was playing Frogger, I never imagined there would be a tournament. And then you said Myth and Ninja, and people went crazy.
Yeah, so have you guys been practicing with your teammates at all?
I played one game with Willie. I played one game, like, last week, kind of just got to know each other. But, yeah, I, you know, everything started, like, charity, fun, but I'm feeling a lot of pressure right now.
Oh, are you?
I'm feeling a lot of pressure right now.
Well, there is a lot of pressure. There's a lot of people watching as well.
I'm just trying to have fun, you know, have a good time. They got all the skins unlocked. You hear about that?
Yes, that's really exciting. And also,
I'm a huge fan of the Nintendo Switch. Now Fortnite on Switch, so you can take it on the go.
Fortnite's on Switch. We got more time to play on the plane.
I've got my strategy down. I'm going to drop into the water and die there because that means no one can kill me.
Loot Lake. Do you guys have a favorite place to drop usually?
Tilted. Nah, just kidding.
Oh, gosh.
Just kidding. Don't go to Tilted.
No, I'm going to hide. Yeah, I'm going to select a really nice bush and squat in that the entire game until Paul George gets knocked out.
So what do you guys expect from this whole thing? Like, after this is all over, do you guys just going to go back and play some more?
Well, I'm going to keep the charity money for myself.
Well, guys, there's so much more coming for you guys today, but we're going to throw it over to Gloom and see what she's got for us.
I'm here with Pokimane and Myth right now. We're going to start with you, Pokey.
All right.
We talked about a month ago, and I was like, are you nervous? And you were like, no, it's just for fun. It's just going to be a good time. But now that your partner designer has been switched out for Josh Hart, how are you feeling?
Honestly, a little disappointed, because I think voice comms with the designer would have been such good content, would have been really fun, really funny. But Josh Hart is really nice. I think it'll be fun either way. I mean, we get to meet celebrities and compete for charity. It'll be a great time.
Are you really going to take control of the comms, or do you think you're just going to like follow him around and let him do it?
I mean, he says I'm better than him, which I don't know if I believe. Either way, you know, we strategized a bit backstage, so I think I know what to do.
All right, well, good luck out there. Moving on to Myth. Myth, you are a patient, top-tier player. Is it weird coming to tournaments like this where everyone expects you to win? Are there any things you do to kind of calm the pressure a little bit?
There definitely is a lot of pressure with that. The expectations are definitely high. I guess the one thing that I just don't want to do is die to fall damage. I have a record for doing that, so as long as I don't die to fall damage, I think I'm going to be pretty good. You know what I mean?
Are you worried about Paul George dying to fall damage? Or?
Nah. Paul George isn't as exposed to fall damage as I am. But at the end of the day, Paul George is a great teammate, and I just want to come out here and do the best that I can with him, of course.
One more question. Since you usually are very smart, good at decision making, do you think that you're going to be a little bit more passive, or do you see yourself being more aggressive in this particular event?
So passiveness and aggressiveness it needs to be taken with a grain of salt. Like, I'm coming into this event playing smart with Paul George. So if you play too aggressive, you end up biting a bullet. If you play too passive, you end up losing opportunities that you should have taken and you should have been aggressive. So it's all about smart play. I believe in a good balance of both is what leads to W's.
It's about taking the opportunity. So you're going to go there. You're going to hit W key. I believe in you. Thank you so much. And back to our casters.
Thank you so much, Gloom. And yeah, so can we just talk about Joel McHale, I just want you to know, sir, that the money goes to the charity directly.
Yeah.
And not to
fairly
you first.
Clearly
it doesn't
stated.
It doesn't go to you first and then go to the charity. It's not how it works, man.
Now, as far as like players like Myth go, I just hope that his duo sticks the landing wherever they end up, okay? I'd hate to see a repeat of recent events.
You hate to see it happen. And you know what? There is going to be some potential moments where some individuals don't stick the landing. Tim, looking at you. You know, Tim the
I'll be a little disappointed, honestly, if it doesn't happen. Maybe just one time. I don't want anybody to get embarrassed. We don't want any memes generated from this, folks. Okay?
Are you kidding me? I want all the memes, bro.
A lot of memes.
All please. The memes. As many as I could possibly get, all right? Because I'm being starved right now. But anyway, we're going to send it over to Justine at the Llama Lounge for some more discussions with our players.
This is the Llama Lounge, if we haven't mentioned and you're just joining us. I've got Robbie and Madeline here. Guys,
hi.
No, what's going on? Because I've seen you streaming, and I've heard that you've been practicing a lot.
Yeah, I don't stream. It'd be too embarrassing.
It is embarrassing, but it's fun.
Well, how's the streams been going? Because I see you on Instagram.
It's good. It's very different to play and then have to talk with your chat at the same time. It like takes a lot of the concentration out of it, so I die a lot.
I think it's props to a lot of streamers because it really is a difficult thing to do, to
entertain
and play.
It's an art form, it really is.
Yeah, I don't even talk to my wife while I'm playing.
So going into this, do you guys have any specific strategies, especially you, since I know you've been practicing?
Yeah, hide.
Okay, that's always a great strategy.
Not die.
That's also...
Because if I don't die, then I win, you know?
That's true. These are really incredible strategies.
But Nick Merckx told me he's dropping Tilted, so if he doesn't...
Well... The drama is already heating up here. Well, we're going to be tossing this over to Gloom to see who else she's got for us to chat with.
All right, guys. I'm here with Ninja and Marshmallow right now. Can't believe you guys are here.
It's an honor, obviously. I am a little bit concerned, though. It's very hot here. Marshmallow, are you concerned at all about maybe heat exhaustion or sightline issues?
No, he's not. No, not at all.
Not at all? And
he's actually got, he's got a bunch of AC units in there. He's good to go.
Perfect. And Ninja, you're one of the most creative players. Your applied knowledge is just unbelievable. Do you see yourself kind of flexing and just doing what you do, just getting away with everything? Or do you think that you guys are just going to like land maybe on the sides of the map?
So it's definitely going to be pretty crazy because we know that a lot of people are going to take this seriously and also try to land on the outskirts, not get in battles and stuff like that. So we're coming up with some creative strategies. And I don't think there will be any flexing until the end of the game.
All right, well, I look forward to hearing the comms between you guys, probably mostly Ninja. Thank you guys so much. I wish you the best, and back to Justine.
Oh boy, have we got something that is really, really exciting for you. I'm making my way down on the stage because we have something that is gonna be called the Boogie Down Challenge. So I hope that you guys are ready for this. We're gonna need everybody on your feet. We are gonna be preparing some dance moves for you. So if we can get those up here, we'll show you guys the dance moves and then you guys need to replicate. Get ready. So here's your dance move. We're gonna be coming around in the crowd and getting some shots. If you wanna make up some dance moves, maybe you'll see them in the game. You never know. Could be something that Epic decides to take. And here it is. Get ready, guys. Everybody, come on, let's get on your feet and let's see this work out. Let's go. It's clearly working out very, very well. You guys have some really great dance moves. This is something that I'm really into. You guys are great. Let's not all dance at once now. Do you guys like memes? This may be one of them.
I think I'll come back to you, then you throw it.
What's that? Just be right here.
All right, guys, those were some really great dance moves. I think some of you did a lot better than the others, but that's where the internet decide, and they could potentially be cruel. But we're gonna head over to the casters because they've got more fun stuff for us.
Justine, an absolute there savage,
was,
I love you.
There was no chill up there.
No, Justine, there was hats zero. Off to you.
I know, that is a credit where credit is due. You know, we'll boogie down a little bit later.
You had some nice moves. The camera wasn't on you, but I will come
camera wasn't on me. I was a little disappointed.
I like when you spun on your head upside down.
Yeah, right.
No one had seen that.
No one caught that, you know? Oops.
I liked the worm. I liked the moonwalk.
Yeah, you know, I
did. Very agile.
Yeah, I was going to say, I was thinking about doing the worm, but, you know, as you guys could tell, my body, I don't have that agility. You know what I'm saying?
Stop it.
You know what I'm saying?
Stop it. You know what you're capable of, okay? These people know. Can we hear some noise in the crowd?
Where's the crowd at?
The dance moves, please. There we go.
Maybe a little donkey laugh.
Oh, the worst.
No, you don't like it?
That thing gives me nightmares. I need to be honest with you.
So the players are getting ready. So, okay, I got to.
Stretching their knuckles.
I'm very concerned here, you know? Marshmallow.
Look at that
right
stare. Look at that stare.
He's focused. He's been training
cold
for this.
Dead eyes.
Honestly, I'm glad I'm
cold,
not playing.
Blurry
look
dead
at that
eyes.
Face. Look at that face. Intimidating. No emotion except for that smile.
Yeah. It's kind of off-putting.
Now, right now, these players scissors. Are given an opportunity to get things settled. You have a bunch of really well-known faces on the screen. Hopefully, if you're in the chats, wherever you're watching
little cousin.
From. You get some hype for these people.
Supporting
please.
The family.
Yeah, you know.
There we go.
Oh how
is he still wearing that on stage?
It is hot out here.
Yeah.
But this man commits.
I'm already sweating, but I'm like sweating even more looking at you. It's uncomfortable. It's uncomfortable. Oh boy.
Now that's some hype right there.
That's what you want. That's what you want.
At home.
That's what you want. That's the duo right there.
These people. It's,
Myth is ready.
Wonderful.
He seems very calm, collected.
Yeah.
He's ready to go, and I'm ready to see him win. Oh, we got El Rubius here.
Nice. Oh, I mean, this guy. I mean, one of the like largest Latin American Latin American YouTubers mm-hmm. that's out there, man.
Mm-hmm.
Demetrius.
Ready
this guy.
To fight.
had a good talk with him earlier. He's feeling actually pretty confident. Talked to him over at catering.
You know, everyone here is taking this very seriously.
I mean, besides Xavier Woods and CDN, but I think everyone else is taking it very seriously.
Yes. It's going to be some really interesting play because nobody here is joking around.
The Three Llama Moon shirt. I'm actually kind of jealous. I need to figure out where they got that. I need to acquire that.
Look at all the people that are out here as well, man. That is just crazy. We're actually going to be starting the first match in just a little bit. We're getting all loaded up into the lobby. Yeah, this is it. They're so hyped up. They're so hyped up. It's off putting. I do appreciate though that Xavier Woods cut off the sleeves on his unicorn outfit.
Because, I commend him.
You know, at some point, right?
I don't have the guns for that. I couldn't pull that off.
Oh yeah, no, I don't. Here we go. This is our first matchup of the day. It is going to be the solo warm-up.
Looks like we got the bus going from west to northeast. You're going to have Tilted is relevant. Retail, Dusty Divot. I wouldn't be surprised if you don't see some people going to Wailing Woods and even further south. Like right now, Ninja and Marshmallow maybe making a play towards Lucky Landing. That's a pretty common spot for Ninja to go. I think he likes the pink tree. It's very pretty.
Yeah. Yeah, well, I think with this solo matchup, too, we're going to see. And also, I just want to mention here, you know, you're seeing the observer mode for the first time.
Which, the first time. Surprise!
As an esports guy, you know, I'm actually pretty happy about that.
Look at that even spread?
I know.
That is kind of
Kind of mathematical.
Oh, there's Myth.
We already had one not sticking the landing in the feed. I didn't catch the name on it, but somebody went down very early.
Oh, no.
You hate to see that happen.
Yeah,
Myth is scouting. There's other people here.
There's
going to
be an encounter.
He's going to land. He's going to get that gun.
Cypher, the first thing he picked up was a trap.
Oh, my goodness.
And a regular skin, because why not?
The no skin.
You know, I respect that,
Dylan
though.
Francis going down.
Sometimes you want to jump in there with the regular skin.
Some sick key binding change plays right now. Incredible gameplay.
And actually, we have a couple eliminations already coming through right now. Dreads ended up taking out Backpack Kid. Oh, it's so sad, so sad. King Richard actually got an elimination on Darkness 429.
And Tim
going down to a
rest
rifle.
Rest in peace.
Tim is out of here.
Tim.
Get out of here, Tim.
Bamsep took out. Typical gamer. A gamer well-known for winning some recent events as well. An excellent player. And
Marcus Scribner did not stick the landing.
Myth taking out Scissor with a shotgun. And we're just kind of hanging out here. Cypher maybe setting up shop on the outside. Does have that trap. Myth, the skin. Anybody seen this skin before?
I've never seen it before.
Seems like it might be new.
Yeah.
Kidding, it's not. It's not. Very sought after.
You're just making a lot of people really, really mad right now. That's what you're doing.
It makes me smile.
I know. You just like bringing sadness to
people. We have little dance moves here.
This little spot behind Retail Row. One of my favorite spots to land.
Now, there's players like Myth out here. Let's see. Yeah, he's got some counterparts. Like Ninja down here, far south end, Lucky Landing. He's going to have to make a little bit of a move to stay relevant within the zone.
He actually does have a player that's going to be around him as well, so that will be Gotaga, by the way.
Don't let him know. I'd like to see these two guys run into each other.
I know.
They're both really good players. Ninja trying to build up, again, making the key binding plays here. These key binding plays are incredible.
Now, you can only do so much until you get into the live game,
agreed,
right?
Mm-hmm. Agreed. You got to wait just a second, you know, get established, and then make sure things are set up how you want. Now, Ninja's taking a second. He's still changing his key binds. We have a view here of what is Lucky Landing, or at least the building that he's in. Now, we saw Gotaga's out there. You might see some interaction between
the two. They
are
very close.
They're both outside the zone, so you're going to have to rotate in at some point. And they're not the only pairing out here. You have a ton of players playing
safe.
They're
right next to each other.
They are right
They're right next to each other.
Ninja's building up.
Ninja's going to go.
The port-a-fort coming out. Gotaga playing a little defensive and some shots.
Port-a-fort goes down.
And fire the walls down.
Oh, Ninja, I mean, that's some streamer loot right there. You get that, turn the corner, and you just get yourself a blue AR. Okay.
Now let me check this. Did he take some shots and then go in hot? The most serious face you can see on this guy. Very focused. But it looked like he took some shots, kind of trying to get Gotaga kind of, you know, moving around, uneasy about his position, and then just kept looting. He switched out to the blue AR. Looks like he's taking another shot at maybe his DPS.
Markiplier just got an elimination as well. Noah J gets one. So the eliminations are starting to come through. We have 72 players remaining in our first matchup, our warm-up solo game. Little Yachty ended up getting an elimination on Hand of Blood. Little Yachty was good.
Will Lowry took out Tariq Cohen. We've got Kinstar here, one of the more notable players to watch, chilling in the middle of Tilted. And he's surprisingly not seeing much. Now, we still have Ninja, Myth on the outside. You see here Myth in the middle of what appears to be a build fight.
This is it. Big moment.
This is just southeast of Retail Road. Bombing the nades in, trying to knock his opponent out.
Performing on the big stage here,
Lupo. Without the no work there. Now, I would like to see Myth push in and do all of the work, if that can happen. But it's going to
be get the shirt, though. Place. He didn't get the shirt.
I'm disappointed.
Actually, he did get the shirt.
I hope so.
I wonder. I know I did.
There we go.
I know I did.
Look at those glasses. Looking stylish, as always. Myth in the iconic Skull Trooper skin.
You know, while we were talking, Muselk, he actually cleaned out Wailing Woods.
Really?
Knocked out everybody in there. And he's just been hanging out in there for the past couple of minutes.
He is just hanging out after.
Australia's very own. I just see him all the way out in the middle of nowhere, just dancing in a forest by himself.
Cypher's out here all alone as well. He doesn't have too much to challenge him right here. Just going for the materials. And Fortnite, like we were saying before, building is a huge piece of advanced gameplay in here. It's one thing to just put down platforms and ramps and stuff, but even Cypher, and we cut over to Ninja here, everybody's gathering up materials.
They're going to run into each other. Gataga's actually going to go right into Ninja. Ninja's taking some shots. Gataga, he's challenging for him, but Ninja's going to end up playing defense here, Lupo.
The quick swap and build, just trying to build up anything. And here you go. Elevation, super important. Building
establishment.
Ninja almost dropped out there. He's going to push here because he got some shield tags on him, so he's in an advantageous position.
He's thirsty. He's thirsty.
Go for it, brother.
Gataga, he's in a world of hurt. So close, Gataga. He's playing defense, but right now, though, Ninja has control. He's just got to play this one out smart. Oh, and look at the health there. You can see the health right on the feed. Ninja tackling up. They're right next to one another as well. This is really tough. And now you're going to see Ninja's going to start building with brick because he doesn't have any more wood. Ninja's going to be very weak. He's 19 HP remaining.
Gataga's
going
in.
Oh, the boogie bomb comes through.
Gataga dropping the dance moves.
Oh, my.
Well played.
Gataga.
What a day. Your first elimination is Ninja. How do you feel?
With a pump, too, in this patch. He did it. He did the darn thing.
That was a good play.
the darn thing
was done. Now, you watch a fight like that from the outside, from an unbiased third-party perspective. And the building was just crazy. The building was also, that kind of was game-changing. Because elevation is everything, especially with a shotgun.
Yep.
You're hoping to get the top down, the blast right on top of somebody. And that's exactly how things played out. Just a quick little whip shot with the shotty, and that was it.
Storm is coming in. Things are getting a little bit tighter.
Exactly. I was just about to say that. With the storm now starting to collapse, things are going to start to get very interesting. Certain players are going to have to make some moves. You know, I see all the way over by Flush Factory, you have Xavier Woods hanging out.
Just doing his thing over there. Love the egg backpack.
You've still got a number of players that are chilling pretty far outside the zone. Now, if you're at home watching, you can't necessarily see this, but.
Is a little fighting down by retail right now, Femsteth? Just knock
really?
Someone. Yeah, Femsteth is fragging.
Steph took another shotgun elimination on Trimax, and Xavier's just hanging out on the outside, moving in for Flush. Flush might have been the safest choice for him, honestly. Very little.
Cypher's in a fight. Cypher's going to be in an engagement currently, but Cypher's going to be in a really good spot. Ends up tagging that player for a substantial amount of damage. It's going to be Jordan versus Cypher, and that is going to do it. Cypher gets the elimination.
That gray AR coming in big there. Was Xavier sneaking like he's on a little reverse crab walk there? What's going on in the outside?
Maybe he's gonna, if he finds someone, he'll just throw some pancakes at him or something. I don't know. I would hope.
Let's take a second, check back in with Myth when we have an opportunity, because he was hanging out. That little build fight, now things played out, and I want to make sure that he's doing okay. Gataga, as we were saying earlier, watching that fight.
Uh-oh.
One shot girl, Jeffrey, Myth, all kind of in the same area right now.
There's a lot that's about to happen, people. It's about to go down.
There is some potential destruction here right now.
The crowd chanting Myth's name.
Oh, yeah. Just don't want to see him go down to fall damage is all I'm saying. Now, Gataga, after winning that 1v1 against Ninjas, he's gathered up a little bit more resource. You see him smacking the trees. He's got a shot. The scope, they are super powerful. Just tap fire away at your opponent. He's going to start pushing in, getting a little more aggressive. No shield, but no big deal, apparently.
And Xavier Woods, I just saw, felt it.
Gataga getting flanked from the side. The northeast shot's coming in. Not sure who that was based on the map. Trying to figure that out.
That was coming from the stables over there. I could not see who that was currently. I think we have Jordan, Gataga, and I believe I saw Myth here as well, but Gataga's still taking even more shots, and here comes Myth on the prowl. He's getting aggressive.
Very aggressive.
Myth coming in, that kind of long-range shotty blast, the green pump. Still, I mean, it's on the green, but it's still super powerful.
Yeah.
It just snipes him from a distance with it. Love it.
Myth has been on the move this entire game, and I really like the movement.
Yeah, his approach. I mean, Myth, he kind of like tailors how he wants depending on the situation. And the guy can play a variety of styles, right? You know, if he wants to kind of turtle up, get into a one by one, kind of play that one out slow, he can. He's capable of doing that. But he's also, oh wait a minute, just as I'm talking about, we got Nick Merckx in here.
Up top. Star.
He's
the
controller in.
Legend.
Oh, look, Kinstar.
He's trying to lure him in.
Now remember, it's 150 damage from the trap, so with Nick Merckx being 100-100, it's not going to take him out. But no. There will still be, I mean, that means there's an opportunity for a crazy shotgun blast, something nutty to happen. And it's all going to depend on whether or not
Kinstar. And surely Nick hears the movement as well, right? Like, that's what I'm wondering as well. Like, he has to hear that.
Nick doesn't look like he wants a part of this right now.
Listen, Nick's just here trying to find an apartment to rent, okay? Kinstar's going to give him some time.
That's why he keeps going back time and time again.
That's why he always goes to Tilted, man. Real estate's a big deal for him, okay?
The rent's too high. You know, that's why he's trying to look for a new place to live.
Now, see this little structure kind of on the outside. I was going to say, if it's not attached to the ground, that thing is very risky. Okay. Kinstar just dropping on down, pushing around the backside of the taco building, looking at the park over here, moving to grandma's house in a moment, it looks like. Just, again, you see all these players. The high skill players are definitely going to try and get as many resources as they can while they're moving. Yeah. Because if you don't have them in the middle of a 1v1, things can go bad.
Cypher just got another elimination.
Now, by Retail Row, it looked like a little bit of a build fight, but he came out on top.
The storm is coming. Jump pad.
Oh, I just heard.
He does have a jump pad.
CDN versus Nanaka. Okay, CDN.
Sees, you don't have a teammate to rocket ride in this situation, so you're going to have to
figure out your own way.
All right.
Oh. Ooh.
Watch those shots. 61
nice
shield.
Shot. Doesn't have any shields,
Nanaka
though.
Nanaka still chilling. The top, that height advantage now.
I don't like that CDN doesn't have the height advantage here. This is so bad.
Oh, seven.
7 HP remaining.
You're going to have to hit this headshot, brother. Let's go.
Nanaka's going for it. That's going to do it. Nanaka will get the elimination onto CDN, the third, the squeeze. He's going to have to wait until the duos match up. But back over to Myth for the time being. Sees a couple players.
Now, you see how Myth's moving south right now. He might be taking an opportunity to try and gatekeep here and just keep anybody out that he can.
That looks exactly like what he's doing with that minigun there. 293 ammo. He's ready to just unload.
Oh, Gotaga got another elimination, but that was going to be inside of the storm. Myth is going to get caught in here as well.
Run, Forrest, run!
Believe.
I keep believing.
Run and then turn around and go, come here, boy.
Oh. That's rough. Those shots were coming from Gotaga. Very, very far out for Gotaga as well. So I'm kind of concerned for him in this instance. But Kinstar is also going to be in a world of hurt, taking a lot of fire.
It looks like Nick Merckx is at the top of the castle building in the middle of Tilted, just taking shots from a distance at Kinstar. Now, I couldn't tell. He's in a pinch situation, which is why Nick is just taking shots when he can. Kinstar, we saw earlier, really, really good at taking advantage of elevation, and that's why he's just building up as high as he can. Wiz just running around the bottom, trying to keep things safe as best he can.
Oh.
The self C4, Kinstar. Yeah. Be careful there, brother.
Cypher just got taken out.
Oh, really?
Yes.
Oh, man. But he's just going to have to stabilize here for a moment.
What a flip in elevation, too.
Yeah.
Frizz building up above. Kinstar dropped down below as he pickaxed out his own structures.
And there's also another, I believe I saw some fire coming from the left side.
Player 3 has entered the game.
Yeah, I'm trying to see who that is all the way over there. But regardless, though, Kinstar was able to restabilize and was able to at least pop the last remaining mini potion that he had left.
Every little bit helps, man. Even right now, though, 95 HP, that means a body shot from a bolt action can take him out of the game. Campfire coming in clutch here. Now you see how he put the platform down, the campfire, and then the ramp above because he's still within the box where the campfire exists. So he's still getting the healing from that. It's still effective, but he's not exposing himself to anybody. He's not sitting in a predictable spot. Even if people see the campfire, he's not necessarily there. He's right above it.
And what he's doing right now is basically just edit peeking, right? Something that you see a lot of top players do where they would go into edit mode and they would, you know, just tap on a couple of the boxes that are there so that they could get some better vision without exposing themselves. It's a very common thing that you're going to see players do. And like I said before, the best players take advantage of it very well. But Kinstar, though, is so concerned about the player that's going to be behind him, which was Frizz. It was all the way up. Wooden tower there.
Interesting that Kinstar would take the opportunity to back out of that. He is relatively close to
Nick Merckx.
Oh!
The disrespect!
Oh, boy. Well, that is going to be a lot of life. Look at that, 529 wood that he was able to obtain. So Nick Merckx going
going deep into the game, man.
It looks like King Richard atop that mountain to the southeast of Pleasant Park. Just got an elimination. Nate Shot's going to be coming down from above.
Courage is lingering right around Pleasant as well.
Noah Jay coming in from Blue Lake.
Just crossing
the lake.
A
little back and forth. Myth dropping some C4 down. Just trying to see. It's like it's fishing with dynamite. You got to see what you can get with it.
Myth looking to get this pick. Finds a player in front of him, but the defense very well played there.
Now this is Nick Merckx, if I'm correct.
Oh!
In the trap. Muzel.
Australia's Mario.
There we go.
He's fragging.
Wow.
Honestly, an excellent game played by Myth. I think he should be proud of how he performed thus far.
Yeah, not bad at all.
Now Nick's still out here.
Oh!
And Nick just took insane damage. Muzelk is fragging. He's got the purple AR out. He's also got a legendary heavy shotgun, which is kind of the meta right now because it's one of the few shotguns that didn't get nerfed.
The zone.
Nick, is coming
you didn't see him.
In.
Nick.
Oh! Muzelk is tearing it up right now.
He's got the loot. He's got the kills. He's doing it big. Five elims.
Wow.
Kinstar, this is the same player earlier that was editing just to peek through. He's built up, this time in a little metal box. Frizz and Kinstar have been friends in this game for a while. I think they're just trying to hang out, and there's a misunderstanding happening. There's no reason they're trying to shoot each other, right? Whit Lowry's still alive, Muzelk, Lolito, Courage, and he's camped at the very edge of Pleasant right
so
now.
So if you look at the current position of the circle right now, it really benefits Lolito as well as JT Brown. A lot of the other players are going to have to push in there. Courage is lingering by the outside, still hanging out in Pleasant Park. King Richard, though, makes a tag happen. He's going to put down some damage, force that player to have to play defense here.
Now, King Richard and Vixar are both exceptional players, so like an elevated fight like this, a top-down fight, Rich has an advantage. He didn't even realize that Vixar backed out, by the way. And Noah is, I feel like Noah's kind of just, he's just listening in from the outside, see if they're, oh, King Richard pushing like crazy.
He wants this.
Take advantage of that jump pad, the launch off it. You don't take fall damage from those things every when you bounce off one, so it's an excellent play to get just as aggressive as possible to push on somebody, and I think he might be trying to take advantage of that.
He's chasing after Vixar. He's chasing.
He doesn't realize Noah Jay's still to his left.
Yeah, he's actually going to get on him. He's going to get pinned from the left if he's not careful. King Richard's going to start to take some damage here.
Be careful, my friend. They're after you. We'll build up the defend.
Oh, I like this. The aggression.
Aggressive.
Here we go. They're going to be right in front of one another. King Richard's going to be super low there on his shield. Ends up losing.
Nice. We have
13
right
remaining. Look at the damage that was just done there, forcing him back.
There we go.
My
what a shot.
Star was not enough.
Well played,
against the
Rich.
King.
Well done. Big Star going down. An exceptional player. I played against him a couple times. But Noah Jay dropping rockets in. This was the pinch we were worried about.
Exactly.
Rich has time to heal up because he has the structure built around him, the metal screw.
Oh, made it inside!
Noah dropping into the box! Oh. Let's go, dude!
My goodness, we're down now to the top eight players remaining in this matchup. You have Noah Jay, Muzelk, JT Brown, Courage, Kinstar, Lolito, as well as Nadeshot. These are the last players left alive in our first match of the day. This is awesome.
JT Brown might get spotted by Courage here. There might be some knowledge there. Yep, there's shots coming out from Courage. Hopefully we can cut to that as fast as we can. Noah, Drezzo about to run into each other. Is that a gray SMG I see from Drezzo? He's playing the meta.
That's some end game loot right there.
One of the best weapons in the game. Don't deny it.
Now, people hate on the gray SMG.
If you notice, this I feel like is a number of these players are taking. If you recall, Joel McHale said he was going to hide in the box.
Yeah.
There are a number of players that are hiding in boxes right now, and I feel like Joel can take credit for a lot of that.
Yeah,
a lot. That's his strategy.
Or to blame.
You know, or to blame.
One of the other. Oh, Muzelk against Courage. Oh, this is such a sick fight. I'm so excited for this. Courage is such a good player, but Muzelk's been on a tear. He's going to have that gold heavy shotgun there, primed and ready to go.
And his shopping
cart.
No
way.
Can't forget.
And
if he pulls out a shopping cart play, I'm going to lose it, dude. Build mounts.
He has to. He's doing it. He's doing the thing.
Are you?
It's for charity. You have to.
You kind of have to.
Get it.
Here we go, brother. Let's go.
Go.
Let's go.
This
Let's
is
go.
What I wanted. This is what I wanted.
Pro Amex Games. Let's go.
Courage. No.
One HP, dude.
1 HP remaining for Muzelk. He's in such a bad spot.
Get that port-a-fort going, man.
He's going to have to at this point.
He's got one in the pocket. He can use it. He has an opportunity. Courage, though, still watching from above. The launch pad. Muzel just going to swoop away, flying like an eagle, brother. Get out of there.
Get
save
those
yourself.
Drops.
No, I mean, he's so weak, he's though.
Tapfire coming in from behind. He's got to build up, defend himself.
My
what is happening?
Can we all just take a moment to appreciate Musub for at least going for the shopping cart play?
Absolutely.
It's going to the highlights.
That's what I wanted,
I like
Cassie.
That.
That's what I wanted. Courage is also going to be swooping in as well onto Trezzo, who's still living with that gray suppressed SMG.
I'm telling you, man, the best, it don't sleep on it, okay? It's like a laser beam now. He's like getting shot at from above.
Wow.
Inch. Two players taking shots from above. Kinstar
and
Paulito both fired.
It was
down.
A good run.
Yeah, I'm not. Listen, between Kinstar and Courage and Noah J, these are three very good players.
This is intense, man.
Yeah. Six players remaining here, folks. It all comes down to this.
Now, a lot of these players, especially I think the ones that are really pushing for a win are going to start. You see here Courage even trying to line up a hunting rifle shot, but they're going to build up in these one-by-ones, get elevation, just play position. But Courage, you can see the mini-map at the top right, he's outside of the zone that's going to be safe, so he's forced to move in a moment, and Noah is not. So he can gatekeep, just wait for it. He's going to build up just a little bit, trying to take a shot on Noah so he doesn't have to push in while being shot at, but I don't think he's got a chance.
Courage is taking a lot of shots there. You have Kinstar has a player in his sights.
So many miniguns in this game.
Yeah.
I think because of the recent changes with weapon damage against structures at range, the minigun has become a really big go-to
it's
for
far more viable
buildings.
Now.
Absolutely.
It just absolutely shreds through
it
structures.
It spits bullets, man.
Yeah. So fast. No reason for you not to use it at this point in time, especially with how these players are going to be playing very defensively. Oh, look at Lolito. So low.
He's just hiding. He's just waiting.
Kinstar, please forget that I'm down here.
I'm just here, minding my own business.
It's okay.
You know?
Just
hanging out.
Oh! Kinstar was having none of that, Lupo. None of that. And that is going to be another elimination. Four players remaining in this matchup. And in the action, Courage was eliminated. So it's Kinstar, Nate Shot, Noah J, and Drezzo, who's still rocking that gray suppressed SMG.
He was sitting inside the box earlier, too. He's still alive. He's still out here. Kinstar making a play, the push coming off the jump pad just to try and fly in. And you realize Kinstar.
They literally have no idea.
He's not looking down at Drezzo. Drezzo could wait to the very last second and win this thing with
he
one
just
elimination.
Let them fight.
Welcome to Fortnite.
You know,
Nate shot at the gas station. Got some big moves for the crowd.
Yes.
America's favorite gamer. Oh, man.
Might as well pass the time.
Yeah, right?
He's delicious. Eating the popcorn. Kinstar building a trap box for himself to hide inside.
Far more intense over here with Kinstar.
Do not push Kinstar because you're going to have a bad time.
Yeah, it's going to be.
You don't want to get caught in there.
A little spiky. Won't feel good. You know, unless you want some acupuncture or whatever.
Kinstar's safe inside the zone. It's starting to close. 25 seconds till the next circle, and we're coming up on the very end, of the forced end of this game. Now, in some pro scrims and competitive play, I've seen situations where it becomes a structure tube, basically a vertical building where people just try and heal like crazy, and the best healer wins. Do you think that's how this is going to play out? Because Nate Shot's pushing in now, but nobody's looking down.
Could very well be the case. Four players remaining. It all comes down to this. I just heard Nate.
I see that. I don't know.
I want to change my DPI down. Out of bunch.
We got the comms coming in here.
Little concerned that he's worried about the.
You know he's
DPI
in a good
right
position
now?
When DPI is the only thing he's worried about.
Exactly. Exactly. Does Drezzo still have that gray suppressed SMG? No. I wonder.
If he doesn't, I'm going to be mad.
Things are not good. Okay, you got the pickaxe out for right now.
Looks like Noah's starting to. He's doing a little bit of checking. Shots come out. He's looking down, I believe, on Nate's shot. Using that purple AR, just spamming shots down. Nate's shot. Building himself up, trying to keep things protected. Now, in a situation like this, Nate Chop, his best opportunity might be what he's being forced to do, and that's build down. You know, edit your way out from the top and get underneath to get inside this massive structure that started to appear out of nowhere. Noah's still looking around, trying to find his targets, see who's left. And it's tough to believe sometimes if you're in a situation like this. that there are actually four players still in the circle because you feel like you can see everything.
The circle is so tiny. These guys are playing so careful.
Noah's building up a wall.
Gray SMG still in play.
Makes me wonder how many campfires Noah might be
starting. Oh, that's the music has died.
Drezzo going down. The Gray SMG legend.
You know, I admire him for.
You made it that far.
I admire
SMG.
Him for sticking to it.
You did, you know? Better than I would have done.
Yeah.
And that's why I'm casting. Nadeshot.
Oh, Nadeshot. Nadeshot goes down. Now it's
1v1 situation.
Kinstar, Noah J, and Kinstar knows exactly what's going on here. But if you're Noah J, you have that slight advantage. Throwing down the pyramids as well as the floors. That's going to give the added defense there to keep him going in this sky base. But Noah J needs to be very, very careful not to get caught off guard.
We're looking at maybe potentially coming up in the end of Noah's materials, too. So Kinstar might be in a situation where he can just outshoot
Kinstar
what Noah can
do. He
doesn't, being below and with Noah building, he doesn't necessarily need it. He can just spam fire this out, and we'll see what's happening.
He's
not using the minigun, man.
The man doesn't have enough mats to get up there. All he can do is shoot.
Yeah, all he needs to do is just keep firing on Noah. Now, I think Noah might go for a – you're going to see it here in a sec. He's going to bounce off the jump pad, fly down, and try and make a play with it because he won't take fall damage. So he can bring himself down, get at Kinstar's elevation.
This is it.
Here we go.
This is it. The minigun comes out. It's going to shred through the structures. Oh, my goodness. The rocket goes down. He's able to stay alive because he used the bounce.
Yeah!
So stylish.
Wow.
Make some noise for Noah J.
Wow.
Look at that smile, that little smirk. He's a happy man. Well done, my friend. Well done. The bounce pad right there at the end made all the difference.
You called it.
When you have to make an elevation change like that and you have a player stuck below you and you really just need to get down on top of them immediately, there's no better option. Minus maybe the shopping cart attempt. I'll be honest with you. It was going to be perfect.
It was worth it.
Absolutely.
We were so close to witnessing what could only be one of the most ridiculous moments in this event. But Noah J gets the win. Congratulations one more time in our first matchup, the solos matchup of the day. And in a little bit, we're going to have Justine with Noah to get the thoughts on that win. But man, what a way for that one to go.
Yeah, we've got some thoughts. Noah, how are you feeling about this? Because this was really intense.
My hands have felt like never as shaky as they have at this point in my life, but I'm so happy that that play actually worked out. I did not think that was going to happen.
I mean, this was down to like the last second, and I mean, there were so many things that could have not went your way, but it did.
Oh, I thought I was done for. I thought he had the breakout from under me. I thought I was going to be falling without a bounce pad, but I just decided I'm not going to die to storm. I'm just going to jump in, and it worked out somehow. So
we got the first match out of the way. We still have two more to go, and you've got your duo partner over here, Madeline. Have you guys been scrimming at all? Have you been practicing?
We actually did. We did a full practice session. She actually carried me through a few, so I'm super excited to jump into the duos and see if we can win some money for charity.
Now, did she carry you, or did she put you in the shopping cart and make it a little easier?
Oh, no, she literally picked me up. I got sniped like 7 times in one game. She was all over it.
Well, I've been watching her streams. She's been practicing for the past couple of weeks. So, yeah, she's been on top of it.
Yeah, I'm super excited to go into these next matches. And that was fun, but I'm ready to go, man.
So any more strategies going into this? Now that you're warmed up, I mean, actually warmed up, because it is really, really hot out here, guys. You may not be aware. But we're playing outside. Is this kind of a new dynamic for you? Obviously, it's got to be.
I mean, when we first came out here, my keyboard felt a little bit like lava. So it's good that it's cooled down a little bit, and I've never played outside before, but LA's always got good weather, so that's always a plus.
So we're actually going to take a little replay here to see how you won this game. So let's go and cut to that replay and take a look. The play. It'll be here soon, we promise.
It was kind of cool.
You guys are chatting over here. We still have got an interview. Look, Courage is up here yelling. You guys don't even know what it's like. Wait, Matt's over here. Hey, Nadeshot. Okay, I know you just won, but Matt was over here, like, freaking out.
Well, I was just really happy for Noah because he's an incredible player, and I'm really excited to see him win.
Yeah, this is going to be intense. Are you ready for this?
Yeah, I mean, strategy out the rip for me and my boy, Toron Woodley. We're just camping. I just camped that entire time. No shame in that. Survival game. We were dancing all our way to top three. We're going to try to do the next game, too.
I think you got this. What about you? Are you excited about this?
Hey, I was just watching this man go to work. He was like this. So I'm just ready to roll.
Well, this is really exciting, guys. We have so much more for you. Congratulations, Noah. Back to you guys at the caster booth.
All right, there you have it. So, Nate shot. I'm disappointed. You know, I was hoping he would be a little.
He's an excellent player. You know, there's a lot of really quality players here.
Made it to the top four?
I believe that was.
So we have some of the highlights, and we'll bring that up in just a little bit as soon as we can. But some moments in that match.
Can we talk about the shopping cart play, please?
Yes.
I think everybody wants to talk about the shopping cart play. I wanted it to happen so bad. All he was trying to do, build a little ramp up and then something to drop off with, get a little bit of momentum going, jump in, and then just ride it to safety.
And then Courage had to go and be the destroyer of dreams. Now, all we wanted was just the, you know.
Yeah, we're just trying to have fun, man. Come on.
You know, so sweaty. But yeah, so as soon as we're good to go, we're going to pull up the replays there. Some more crazy moments. Ninja going out early in this matchup. These are the final moments of the game, though. This is when Noah J was just playing defense, and it really, things started to get crazy as soon as that gold minigun came out. That's when things just got absolutely mental.
It was kind of the game changer because it created an environment where Noah knew he wasn't going to be safe. He had to make a move here. He was trying to just keep up the surface, build it up, and see what he could do with it. And Kid Star basically said, listen, sir, I'm going to need you to come down and talk to me because I will not have you above me like this. And that's exactly how things played out. Like I said, you see a lot of competitive players do the floor and then the pyramid above. It kind of creates a double layer of protection. And Noah, he didn't seem to mind. Just dropped in, said hello with the rocket, and there we are.
Wow, what an ending to that match.
I didn't care. Was he trying to spell something in
Maybe.
The edits? I think he was. No, you sending a message, brother? What's happening?
Yeah, that was just that was such a fun ending to that one. But as I mentioned before, we also had we got to talk about it. Ninja going out early to Gotaga.
That was an excellent play, dude. Just the fight here, like we showed earlier, Ninja's a really, really good elevated player. He's going to build up, stand top of his opponents because he knows the height advantage is extremely key. Even right there, the tack shots only hitting 77. He had the boogie bomb making his opponent drop some dance moves, but it could not clutch it.
Yeah, so there you have it. Ninja, though, we'll have to try again in a little bit because we're going to have our duos warm up, and then the big matchup will be coming up in just a few where $3 million are up for grabs for charity. But for now, though, I believe we have Gloom over at the floor with one of our players from that matchup. Gloom, what's going on?
Thank you so much. I'm here with Musalk right now. Unbelievable. I thought you were going to be jet-lagged, but you did what you do.
No. You know, I feel like someone really had to represent the meme side of the game, you know, bring that stupidity in. I was initially going for the sky bridge. People started shooting me. It created problems. Didn't end up that way. But you're at the top of a mountain. You see a shopping cart. You got to go for it.
Well, I really appreciate that. And I know with this tournament, survival is key. It's not a limbs. It's more about an event for survival. Do you think that you're still going to be aggressive and go for those limbs, or do you think that you're going to push a shopping cart, maybe use any sort of weapon you can?
I feel like when it comes to when I'm actually trying to win money for my charity, I'm going to play hard, but I got two games to mess around and push shopping carts down mountains, and I'm absolutely going to do that as much as I can.
I love that approach. You're just chilling out, having fun right now, and then you're going to take it a little bit more seriously, but not too serious for charity. Thank you so much, Musalk, and back to you, Justine.
I am here with a very fashionable duo. We've got Dylan and Jericho. Guys, well, first of all, let's chat about these outfits. They're nice.
Thank you.
Coordinated.
At least you're dressed for the weather, because I think some people miss the memo when they're in sweatshirts.
Yeah, actually everybody did.
Yeah, that's okay. They found out very quickly. So you were out fairly early. Not the first, but you were the first to come over for an interview.
Yeah, it was a gameplay thing. The thing is, I don't want to show off my skills yet. I want to wait for the duos. So I decided, let's let them think that I suck, and then I'm going to come real hard all over them.
For sure. That's crazy. A lot of information. So anyway, moving on, strategies that you guys may have. you know, that's it. Mic drop right here. I think we might need to throw the mic at this point. Anyway, this is all for charity. It's going to be great.
we have a lot of strategies that are a little more PG coming in next, so I'm excited to see what we can accomplish together.
We're building a Madonna cone thing. Sorry.
I'm crying.
We're competing at the highest level.
It's all right. Well, there's so much more that's going to be happening here, and I'm terrified for what might happen. But you know what? This has been amazing. We also are going to be going to check out what is in the fan swag bag, and I've got a little sneak peek at it, but it's awesome. Check it out, guys.
Thanks, guys. Zeke and Mooney here, and we're hanging out upstairs in the Sunset Club to talk about some awesome prizes that you at home can win.
We'll be giving away 10 giveaway bags over the course of the stream, and each one will have one Fortnite foam pickaxe. Just, all right. A Fortnite visor to keep away those harmful sun rays. One of five Fortnite enamel pins. I myself rocking the llama.
Boogie bomb for me.
And last but not least, a Pro-Am lanyard to really rock out the fact that you were watching this event and here for all the excitement. I do think I'm forgetting one, maybe?
You are, Mooney. Ladies and gentlemen, you'll also get 2,500 V-Bucks. 2,500. You'll also earn an exclusive spray that you can only get for tuning in to the Pro-Am. Okay, Mooney.
Fantastic. All right, so how do you win these bags? Keep doing what you're doing. Hang out in chat. Interact with us. Fortnite Pro-Am's going on. It's hype. Back to you guys at the desk.
All right, so we're waiting for our next matchup. You got Golden Boy and Lupo here. I mean, you know, really, just so many just funny moments in that game. Fun moments and intense moments. I do appreciate that Nick Merckx stuck to his guns, went to Tilted.
Oh, yeah.
You know,
a man of his word.
Yeah, that's right. Did Tim go retail? I'm assuming.
It's his home and native land. Yeah, yes. But I will say, though, I have no idea because he kind of got knocked out pretty early. might be. I don't think that's the strategy that he was going for, but it's what happened, you know.
Yeah, exactly. You know, you hate to see it happen.
You hate to see it.
But yes, so we're going to be getting ready for the next matchup. So the next game will be a duos matchup, and very similarly to the solo matchup, it's going to be a warm-up game so that the players can get acquainted with one another. Okay, get ready to kind of create that chemistry, and then we have, as I mentioned before, the big matchup, $3 million up for grabs for charity, and I mean $1 million going to the
That's
winner.
Insanity. It's a lot of money going to, like you said, a good cause, and you've got a lot of players here, a lot of big names. It's nothing but fun, you know. It's entertaining. I'm having a blast. I hope you're having a blast. I hope the crowd here is having a blast.
Seems
too.
Seems like everyone's having a good time.
That first game was intense, right?
That was good. That was good. You gotta. Actually, if I'm one of the people that's over there by the shade, I'm actually feeling pretty good.
It's a good day.
It is a good day. But as the day begins to progress, you know, it's going to get a little cooler over here at the arena. But the games are going to heat up in just a little bit. So let's continue to talk more about this before we get set up and move forward here, because there were more moments in the matchup. I do want to give credit to Kinstar. We haven't really given him a lot of love here.
He had a lot of excellent plays, even just like counterbuilding against his opponents and getting really good positioning, knowing when to escape and play with the circle and rotate at the right time. You didn't see him running out in the open like crazy. He was doing the edit to look through like we were talking about, so you can see through the walls and not expose yourself to shots. He's just trying to shoot a shot, man. Sometimes that's what you got to do.
Yeah, sometimes you just got to shoot your shot.
There you go.
Well, all right. So we have some amazing announcements that take place earlier today, and that was that Fortnite is coming to the Nintendo Switch. I'm so excited for that.
I'm really mad I didn't bring mine.
I know.
I
brought mine. I downloaded it. Yes, be jealous. But, yeah, so let's actually go ahead, take a look at the trailer one more time. We'll be right back. Available right now, Fortnite, on the Nintendo Switch.
Download it or you're banned. I'm just kidding.
Why would you do that? Why would you even say
it's
that?
It's a joke. I will never ban you or any of these wonderful people that have decided to join us today. Thank you so much for coming. I appreciate that.
You just keep pandering to the crowd.
Well, they're fantastic. It's not my fault.
All right. Well, let's actually send it over to Gloom, who has one of our players standing by. Gloom, what's going on?
Thank you so much, Golden Boy. I'm here with Fragger Extraordinaire, One Shot Girl. How you doing?
I'm good.
I noticed recently that you
Your partner Nick A30, Tfue and Cloak broke a record 53 kills on Friday Fortnite. How did you achieve that?
Yeah, we tied the PC record, but honestly, like, Nick is like the best partner and the FaZe guys are just phenomenal players. So I think just really good teamwork and playing with really skilled players allowed us to just kick some butt. So yeah.
You and Nick's synergy, it makes me so happy. Do you think you're going to be able to have that same synergy with Jack today?
I think so. Jack's awesome, and you know, we got to hang out for a little bit and talk, so I think that really helps, you know, at least getting to know each other, and hopefully that'll just help us be the best teammates we can be.
All right, well, thank you so much, and best of luck to you. We also have El Rubius here.
Hi, how are you doing?
I'm great. It's an honor to meet you. I can't believe it. You're such an inspiration on YouTube. Wow. I know you're taking
Thank you. Do you speak Spanish?
I wish.
Okay.
I literally watch you with captions on. And
sometimes
when it's a live stream, it's like not correct. And I'm
No.
I pretend. So what's your strategy today?
My strategy is to play like really camping, like not get out, because when I go out, it all goes bad. So, but I'm happy if any of my guys from Spain win. Like Lolito went fifth, I think. So I'm happy if Wooly Rex or even Lolito wins and they take the cup home. That would make me really, really happy.
I did review some of your gameplay, and I noticed that you really like to sit in one by ones and like take skill shots. Are you gonna do?
Oh, yeah.
You're gonna do a lot of that today, huh?
I'm gonna try to do a skill shot with the what's it called in English? No. It's the one you cast down and makes you jump.
The impulse grenade.
Impulse grenade. Yeah. I'm gonna try to make one with those.
Well, I can't wait to watch you. Can't wait to watch you in the duos. It's duos from now on. So good luck.
Yes,
good luck to
go.
You
Thank
and
you.
Your partner. Thank you
Thank
so
you.
Much.
Bye.
Bye. All right. Back to you, Golden Boy.
All right, thank you so much for
He's
that.
So nice.
Yeah, he really is.
He's so nice. And he mentioned impulse grenades. We saw, King Richard using the jump pads, the bounce pads to just fly at his opponents and try and make some plays. I love to see that. That's what Fortnite's about for me, is the shenanigans. And so when players just kind of embrace that and try and get a little crazy, it feels good. I like seeing that. I want to see more of it, especially because we have the duos warm-up game coming up next. Oh, my. Look at the eyes. Marshmallow stop.
Every time
you're creeping me out, brother.
It makes me feel things. You know, honestly, it really does. It really does. We got this next matchup starting up. And as a matter of fact, it seems like the battle bus is all loaded up. And it's now time to start our second match. Come on, crowd. Let's make some noise.
Let's
get hyped up. We got one more game after this one. But this is the warm-up matchup, the duos game, where we're going to see the synergy between these teams, between these duos. And let's see where we drop
it. Now it appears a whole bunch of players dropped out immediately. You could see a couple actually looking at Tilted, which surprised me a little bit. Sniper Wolf making a move in here, just trying to fly in, find somewhere safe to land. And we're going to have a lot of players doing similar things. Looks like the middle of the map might be pretty empty. We have players, if CD in the third does not end up in Dusted Divot, we have a problem. Ali A. Going all the way to north side, Wailing Woods, risky reels. Going to be a very open field in the middle of the map. We have what looks like 3-4 teams around Tilted Towers. We've got a lot going Junk Junction. A couple, Myth and Paul George landed Snobby Shores. They're solo there. We have Josh and Pokemon. Josh Hart going all the way to the north side.
We got a good spread here. I like this. And actually, some shots already starting to go down, but just a lot of activity.
Nobody
on the map.
Shots coming.
Arubius. Oh,
Lil Yachty go down.
Lil Yachty, that's it.
Such Arubius, like I was saying, such a nice guy, and immediately thirsts in game. Wow.
There's no chill.
Hey man, this is serious, okay?
Some serious.
There's a lot
stuff
on the line. Actually, in this game, there's kind of nothing on the line. So is that a negative thing? Just to thirst early like that? You'd think he was running the Rust Lord scan, right?
Tim the Tap Man just got knocked out by Expert Thief. One Shot Girl gets knocked out as
Tim,
well.
Tim, what are you doing?
Oh, man, a lot of good players are just starting to fall. Drop like flies. You actually have one in front. Oh, no.
Knocked out.
Ali A is in a world of hurt.
All right, Pete, listen close. I need you to pick up a gun.
disrespect.
Oh, wow. Muzog,
no
just
chill.
Munching away popcorn. Lightly salted, little bit of butter.
Pete Wentz to the rescue. He's going
Come
for
on,
it.
Pete.
I think that you may have just telegraphed where he's coming from. Oh, this is going to hurt. The shots are going all over the place, but there you have it. Ali A, Pete Wentz, you out of here. Was Musico just eating the popcorn the whole time?
Honestly, my favorite emote because it's like a, hey, we're just having fun,
this is
right?
Great.
Thanks for entertaining me. Delicious popcorn. Party next door, and El Rubius taking over Haunted Hills. Just hanging out.
I like the Haunted Hills drop. You actually get a lot of resources. You also get a couple chests out of this one as well. Pretty decent location, but El Rubius ends up losing his teammate.
Frag's got a knockout from Partner Sword, which means all pressure on El Rubius to make a play here to try and take out both at the same time.
And there you have
it. The clutch!
Clutch plays from El Rubius is going to keep them going in this matchup.
Yeah, hopefully he's got some sort of healing. Party, you're a mess. Clean yourself up, brother. Reggie getting a couple knockdowns. Reggie appears to have thirsted Noah Jay, the winner of last game, so he's out already. Pokey and Josh hanging out in the Anarchy. I feel at home in the farm landings. Being from Nebraska, there's only three people that live there. It's very empty. So the farms, I mean, look, it's just like home. It's just like home, Golden Boy.
Yeah, this is, you know, okay. Well, what are we, taking a look right now. You got Anarchy Acres here, and Scissors is going to get knocked down, but oh boy, shot. CDN.
The two shot, the two
whoa,
pump.
Whoa, 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 whoa. Just heard him. My DPI. Everything's kind of screwing up.
The wild aim.
He can't get CDN's together. Yeah. Lyrics out. Xavier Woods, though, comes in with the save.
No, things aren't over yet. Reggie's still alive. Sees one shot. Xavier's going to have to clutch up here and save his teammate, who does not know apparently how to use a mouse right now.
It all comes down to Xavier Woods because CDN apparently.
Shotgun blast. There we go.
He does it. Through the power of positivity, they were able to come out on top.
C's not looking too good. What is that, 15 HP tops? Him and Xavier are going to have to make try and scrounge up what's left of Anarchy here and put together their any healing they have.
It was a logistic issue.
You're the banter between the two of them. I'm not sure what's going on with C's mouse, but he's got crazy high DPI right now. Valkyrie for the beats. Getting eliminated. It's too bad. Now, it's not a big deal, though. It's just a warm-up for them. So getting knocked out this early, it's okay.
Exactly.
It's just a warm-up. Doesn't count.
Yeah, just a warm-up. Doesn't count. It's no big deal. Focus up for the last game. Prince Royce, Willie Rex, both sitting pretty. Look at this. Look at his setup. Purple AR. Purple scope they are. The green TAC. TAC right now kind of the go-to. Nate Chow taking out Janine in the feed there. That's too bad. You hate to see that. a handful of frag grenades. I think they're just clearing through retail. There's nobody else there right now. They can take it easy, kind of meet
Lolito's
the neighborhood.
Taking some fire, as a matter of fact, though.
We're going Ron, very northwest corner. It looks like they just rolled out of maybe the hotel.
Well, I've got that many.
The area between the hotel and Junk Junction. A little 2v2 situation.
You know, for Robbie A saying he was going to play a little bit more passive.
Ooh.
Oh, boy.
The shots, TAC shotgun coming out, trying to build. You see, he just throws the wall super quick. They hit it. And the
play.
Let's go.
Nice.
Well done.
There.
Well done. And now they get to collect from the loot pinata post fight.
Wow. Good engagement there. That's going to net them some solid eliminations. And I would say, you know, with 58 players remaining in this matchup.
It's going a lot faster, isn't it?
I'm actually kind of surprised.
Well, now in a public match, at this point, I feel like there might be 12 players left. depending on where.
Oh, yeah, everyone just went tilted and dusty. So.
Josh and Pokemon stuck in a fight here. Back up at Anarchy. Just trying to build and defend. A couple layers is all you need so you can start taking shots at your opponents. And it looks like they're going for a pinch. Josh, Pokey are stuck on like a single structure. You've got one going to the north, one going to the south a little bit, trying to get a flank here. Dreads and Artie in a pretty good position.
Yeah, right they're now. Putting a lot of pressure onto Pokemon and Josh. So that is just going to force them to continue to play some defense here. And I think if you're in this situation and you're a fan of Pokemon and Josh, you are a little concerned. But wait a minute, I stand corrected.
Josh Hart getting the knockdown on Dreads. You don't want to thirst yet. You can use him as bait. Here comes
the
shot. Headshot. There it is.
Woo!
Good
nice.
Shot, Josh. Well done.
Hey.
And those comms.
The disrespect.
Oh, and the kiss of death. All right.
Backpack Kid, Loser Fruit, hanging out in retail.
Backpack Kid went out a little early in the solos matchup.
Look, we've got a little 1v1 situation. I didn't realize Whit Lowry knocked down the bottom of this port-a-fort. Lucifer trying to drop the structure out from underneath Backpack Yeti. He's moving up. Now that's surprising because maybe Lucifer did not realize Backpack Yeti is actually on your team. Lucifer, you don't want to knock the structure out from underneath him.
No, that's
but I guess it's bad. Not a big deal. The elimination.
Oh, right. Ooh. Oh, that's a lot of
build
damage.
And defend. Build and defend.
And the storm now starting to come in. It's creeping, but they're going to be close, so they should be okay for the time being. Kitty Plays, though, is going to be to the left of him here by Retail Row.
I witnessed Kitty Plays and Chandler Riggs practicing on stream, I believe, earlier this week. And, right there, you can see one of the issues we've dealt with from time to time, phasing through structures, but it's okay because they're going to drop behind Noms, a place that I'm often caught shopping for my groceries. And the top, like I said, the top-down view, you got Chandler and Kitty both moving up on the same structure. You have to be careful there because if you're on the same ramp, the same structure built up, and it gets knocked down, you're in a bad spot. Just drop and rock.
Oh.
Yikes.
Oh, man, that is Kitty. Oh!
You got to be careful there, Kitty. There's a trap.
150 damage. Those take a big bite out of you.
Well, the good news is, at the very least, she'll have the med kit as well as the big pot, and you know, a little dance. Because why not? Why not? Oh, I know Rubius and Party Next Door are out of the game. That is, some friendly fire there.
You could see that Rubius karma for the dance moves earlier from Rubius, maybe?
Potentially. And, you know, Ron Funches and Lolito actually doing a really good job. Yeah, Myth and Paul George.
They're stuck down at the edge here. They're towards the edge of the circle. Kind of a disadvantageous position because Ron and Lolito have height, they have the circle, they have everything going for them. They're going to see a rotation across to the north side, kind of try and line of sight with the hills and the trees if they can. Back over.
CD on the third and Femstaff, their teams, they're fighting each other right now. They just ran into each other. I was watching them.
Looks like they're right on the river right now. We have two tap getting thirsted by Frizz.
And things have just, I tell you, man, everyone's just on pins and needles right now. Mm-hmm. You can just tell, like, the tension in the arena, the tension on the stage. Everyone is feeling it here. And
now, this is a 1v1 between John and Frizz to save Jeff, who's stuck down at the bottom right now, knocked down. So
can he do it?
Frizz's teammate slowly ticking out. But if he makes a play here, you get a pickup, get a little build, a little edit, a little spice. You got to get in there. You can't wait too long, though. Uh-oh, no shots. That looks like a lack of knowledge.
And it looks like
he doesn't know where he is. He lost him, man.
And it looks like John actually does not have anything to really heal with here. So, you know, if you are a betting man, advantage. Actually, I stand corrected. Does have those two minis, but hasn't elected to pop them
yet.
I'm kind of surprised that we haven't seen that.
Going for a clutch revive here. Scoop up your teammate. 2v1 is much better than 1v1, let me tell you.
Oh, yeah. Wonder what's in the kit. Oh,
and it's like,
you hate to see those
adjusting some DPI settings.
Changes.
I can't wait to see
Ninja's in a fight.
On Twitter, Ninja Marshmallow, the elevation. Like I said before, height advantage, very important. Ninja knows that. You see a lot of the plays that he makes, a lot of the clips that he posts on Instagram and Twitter, messing with settings. Maybe in the middle of a fight, not the best idea, but we'll see. We'll see, Marshmallow. Maintaining all the way above. He's got the eagle eye view with that that heavy shotgun.
He can't see out of his hat, but he has got a pretty good view.
I don't know how he's doing this.
Okay. Fun insider fact. The Marshmallow uses echolocation.
Yeah, okay. That makes all the sense now. You know, just kind of
a little build. 1v1 build fight here. Marshmallow's watching from above. Ninja's teammate's going to be
he's got the map out. Maybe.
He's trying to build, just protect. Oh, let's go.
What a play.
Marshmallow with a shotty.
And there's that heavy. That thing is a shredder. It goes through. It dominates. I think that we were talking about it yesterday. Actually, who was that? I believe I was speaking with Ninja, as a matter of fact, yesterday. Yeah. We were talking about it, and he had mentioned he's like, right now I think heavy shot is the way to go currently. So
what's your preferred shotgun setup?
I love, well, in the current meta, I love the heavy shotgun. Preferably two of them. Legendary. They're hard to find though.
She knows what's up.
You go pump to the unicorn
and
shotgun
SMG?
Setup.
Not bad.
Typical gamer, what you want to do it in from the outside zone. Josh going down. Pokimane all by herself out here.
Just look at that. Pokimane's
got this. Easy.
Look at the pickaxe fight. Typical gamer.
Typical gamer just trying BM with the bludgeon swing there. Is that what I saw?
I don't know. We'll have to ask.
Rotation of weapon selection. Liam by himself, blue pistol. He's got some plunge. The sticky nades.
He's got my jam though. He's got that suppressed pistol. That's my jam.
Jaylen and Kitty dropping rockets to the south. Just trying to see what they can do. Smart Redway not looking good as far as HP.
Nayshot actually just took out Paul George, by the way. Just want to comment on that.
Missed teammate goes.
And
Musso played himself.
What happened?
But Myth came in with the shotgun elimination.
Avenging his teammate.
As it should be. As it should be.
Typical Gamer is doing a lot of work. Vince Staples is a bit of a beginner with Fortnite.
I also have to talk about something here as well, guys. Courage has been hanging out in Pleasant Park and has literally not left, looking to buy a house.
Really?
Now, Chandler and Kitty have a really good spot here. They're just going to spam out the walls. It's like they're knocking on the front door, just trying to say hello. Chandler, I expect big plays here. He's got an opportunity to move in.
Chandler can go huge, finds a player in front of him. Shots are out. Still, though, that pressure from up above, Kitty really supporting him. Very much. Oh, man.
Wait. Chandler went out because Kitty plays fell and didn't stick the landing.
Mm.
The whole team eliminated.
Yep. Look at this strategy.
Ty and Vic, is it like a party house? What's going on here?
Hey, you know, just
Big Star, I'm gonna need you to explain yourself.
I'm looking at where they are currently on the map. They're more on that north side, so like the northeastern portion.
They're in the circle, though.
They're in the circle. That's what I was gonna say. They're in the circle, northeastern of Pleasant Park. So they are in a, you know, they're in a decent location. I think they're playing to their strengths here. You know, they're playing to their strengths.
If you're at home and you've chosen this play style, you know that Vicstar and Ty Dolla $ign could go take a bathroom break and come back and be fine.
Yes.
This kind of thing I think should be played in blitz mode just to prevent this sort of thing from happening.
Demetrius and Gotaga building up inside the factories of Loot Lake, just trying to, you know, maybe they're trying to start a business together, establish a base of operations.
And also, you know, they're very wealthy right now because they have a lot of materials.
They do have a lot of materials.
They're rich, they're important, they smell good.
That's right.
It's true.
On some antiperspirant, they're rocking.
Vince Typical going to rotate in. You have the Storm is going to force engagements here. You're going to have players that have to fight. And hopefully, now there's only 8 AR rounds left, particularly right here, but it might not matter. He's got the hunting rifle. We've got some eliminations going. East side of the circle is a hot zone right now. You have a lot of teams coming in all at the same time. Somebody's got to build a one by one, sit in the top, and just gatekeep the whole time. And I guarantee you they will they'll come out victorious from this. Kinstar and Sean might have the right idea. Honestly, kids are, again, building up that little metal ramp structure to stay safe up top. He's got rockets. He has an excellent view of the map. You can just see people coming in. He's got a bunch of ammo. This is looking like a good team right now.
This is, yeah, Kinstar once again putting himself in a situation for victory. Just got to make the closeout happen.
Exactly. Now, they are outside of the next safe zone. You see the roof going up, trying to protect the top of that metal structure.
Oh,
wow.
Ouch.
What a shot. 47 crit to the shield in there. And is that a massive structure that I saw to the north where it looks like Marshmallow Ninja, which, by the way, if you haven't noticed, Marshmallow and Ninja still have Skyart underneath them in their structure, and I don't think they know. Willard X taking out Smart Redway.
They've got a squatter in their house.
They do. I wonder if he's paying rent.
No.
And if so, how much do you think Marshmallow Ninja would charge? Is it in chug jugs?
Well, yeah, it has to be. Maybe they could just go knock in and request the materials the old-fashioned way, you know?
Willard X having an engage here. Typical
Vince is he's tackling this one. He's going for it. They're going to be right in front of one another.
Typical Gamer, though, securing
Vince exploded Willy Rex.
An elimination's an elimination, man.
Take it how you can.
Well done. Typical Gamer.
Vince, he did say, I'm new. And Typical was like, I got you. Don't worry about it.
I think he was sandbagging. There you go. Great minds think alike. And look at this here.
These two they're writing their memoirs. Maybe they're talking about life. They could be doing their taxes. Who knows?
It's not the season, though.
We're going to have a conversation.
Maybe they're just planning like a joint vacation together.
Otaga and Demetrius Jones gonna push up there. Typical gamer just picked up Vince.
Oh, they're both lit up right now.
This is rough. Typical gamer is going to go down. Vince Staples all by himself.
Vince, no pressure.
It's all up to you. We're about to find out.
Yeah, we're about to find out if the skinny carries strong heat.
30 HP in a dream. 30 HP in the dream is dead. Okay.
A brave pickaxe decision there, but I commend you for it. Well done. Gotaga, Demetrius, both good shots. Gotaga actually getting tap fired from the top of the mountain. I think Courage and Ken still up there just looking down. Marshmallow Ninja still just hanging out.
Todd Dahlstein and Vixstar finally pushing up. They've decided that they want to look for...
They're leaving their shack?
They are leaving their shack.
That's too bad.
Okay, so there's a... Is that
purple
is that,
AR, purple heavy shotgun.
Yes.
Blue hunting rifle, one of my favorite setups. And look at this man's shields. He's sitting on a chug jug and two fulls. He's got a campfire, 800 wood. He's doing great on materials.
It's a little intimidating.
Honestly, I'm not surprised.
And a lot of angles.
He's taking the launch pad out just so nobody can try and swoop up on him.
Uh-oh.
We have a little bit.
Courage is going to back away here. Courage is going to go for it. He's going to go for it. He's able to pick
one. Great shot.
That was going to be some damage going through there. Courage, oh, the storm's going to come in. Courage doesn't have any shields anymore. Kinstar does get the elimination on Ty Dolla Sign, just so you know. Vixstar, who's also lost to the storm, unfortunate to see that happen. But now Courage, he has really nothing to work with here. He's going to be in a really bad spot. His teammate's going to be in the storm yelling, help me. But Courage says, no, I need to try and make these plays. I'm an optic. I want to get, at very least, a sniper montage clip here for my troubles. But I just don't think that he's going to be able to do that, given the situation.
It actually cost Kenneth his spot in the game right now. It looked like he ticked out of the storm, which...
Oh, Marshmallow!
Wait a second.
Marshmallow gets knocked down.
1v2 situation. All right, Ninja. The rematch. Let's go, brother.
This is it. How fitting that these players are running into each other. But Skyre, Demetrius, everyone is in this location currently. It's Ninja versus the world here. Skyre just managed to shotgun Demetrius, and Demetrius is down out of this fight. So it's going to be up to Gotaga to keep his team in this battle. Marshmallow, though, didn't stick to landing earlier.
Ninja taking just a second here. He has a chance to pop the chug jug. And Skyre, they're like right next to each other. Did you not realize? Does Skyre not realize?
Slinger's coming in.
I guarantee you the tension on Ninja's face right now is ridiculous, because he just popped a chug jug literally feet from his opponents, and I don't think they realized he was there.
Ninja's POV. We're in Ninja's POV, and he was able to put down some damage. Marshmallow, though, is about to go out.
That's a save that might not
He's playing happen. Defense. He's playing defense. He has no other choice but to play defense here.
No pressure, but there's about 50 bad guys around here.
Everything is happening in this area. Gotaga, though, trying to stabilize, only has the minis to be able to keep himself in this one, but Kidstar is going to get the elimination. That's a fourth place finish, though,
Ninja
for Gotaga.
Took out Courage in the middle of all that, and we have literally the last four players right here. One team of two and two solos left.
Skyheart's down.
1v2 situation.
It's all up to Ninja. Ninja versus like two members here. Can Ninja make it happen?
Can
it's a situation
it?
That he's been in so many times in the past, but he goes, gets the jump pad. Maybe he's going to try and see if he can go and reposition here. That could be a potential. Look for the high ground. It's just such a pressure-filled situation for Ninja, but if there's one player in this moment who can clutch it out, it is certainly going to be him.
We've seen him do it before. He can do it again. Just has to get up above.
Here we go.
The launch pad
swooping in. He has vision. He knows exactly where the enemy team is going to be located. Ninja's up top. Kinstar, though, going for it. Ninja, does he get any damage down quite yet, though? Gets
nice
four,
shot.
Drops down in front, though. He's going to take some damage. Oh, the
Lefurian
takes out Sean. One more player left alive. Woo. It's going to be Kinstar versus Ninja.
Both players 1v1. Take a second to heal up.
Oh, he's got the rockets.
He's got the rockets, but Ninja has to play defense here.
Oh, he might even have time to res here.
He knows exactly where Ninja's going to be. Oh, that's going to be a considerable amount of damage. Oh, Ninja's going to be in a bad spot here. Run it away. Ooh. Tail between his legs. Kinstar on him. Ninja, can he clutch it out? Ninja! Oh! Kinstar gets the win.
What a play.
Wow.
Kinstar's been playing out of his mind both games already, and it shows. What a finish. What a finish.
Whoa. Well played, though. Well played.
Can we make some noise for our
That was
Kinstar,
amazing.
Please, let's go.
Let's make some noise.
Let's
Come on,
go.
Guys. What a game from South Korea. Kinstar.
Incredible plays there. Ninja stuck kind of in a position. You see the structure there. Things get pretty crazy when you get in a build fight like that, especially when you have a number of competitive players stuck in the same area. Build knowledge, the ability to swap, to ramp and wall and your floors, and even incorporate some pyramids is crucial. And of all the players here, all the competitive players here, Ninja has that in spades. He's got the knowledge. He has the ability to build. And I think Kinstar just got a little bit ahead.
Kinstar also had the rocket advantage as well, yeah. Right? I mean, as soon as those rockets went down, it put Ninja in such a bad spot. I don't think he was expecting that he was going to take so much damage out of that one. I think he thought as well that he was able to position a floor to be able to cover for himself. It was just a rough situation for Ninja to be in, especially after taking just a huge chunk with those rockets.
Now, earlier we had a moment to listen to Ninja and get some feedback on maybe what he expected to do during these three games today. And he said before we get to the last one, the charity game, he was maybe going to play around a little bit more than some would expect. Now we have one left. We've got $3 million for charity on the line this last game. Do you think he's going to change up his play style, going to play a little slower? Because that game, he did sit the top of that mountain. That was the most conservative I think I've seen him play in a long time. And he was really pushed for that win.
Yeah, I do want to know, whether or not he's going to try and change up his style. But we're going to find out in just a little bit. For now, though, we have Justine down on the floor with Kinstar.
Oh, we're here, and we've got some things to chat about, guys. Okay, so congratulations, first of all, on the win. Did you think that it was going to come down to this?
Can you repeat?
Did you think that it was going to be this close of a call? I mean, getting into that, like, this was pretty intense.
Yeah, pretty close to the end. I mean, he could kill me. I was at 28 HP.
Yeah, so you guys both are playing for charity, which is incredible. Do you guys have a specific charity you picked out for?
I'm doing a mentally disabled group home back home in Montana.
What about you, for your charity?
Le Refuge or Le... Well, I don't remember.
That's okay. This is, the best part about this is it is all fun and it is for games. But we are doing this all for charity. But you guys are here. Now, this was not the official game. So going into this, do you guys have any different strategy that you'd like to change up for the next one?
No.
No. So you're going to do the same thing.
It worked. He got all the kills.
That's true. I think we will have a replay for you guys if you want to check that out. But this is really exciting. So congratulations.
Yeah, thank you.
We're going to head back to the casters. Congratulations.
Thank you.
All right, so let's take a look at some of those highlights there. I mean, look at them. They're, I mean, Sean O'Malley and Kinstar are so excited after that one. But, I want to see some of these moments. I mean, there we dress up again. Was this actually, this was from the first game that we saw.
This is all the buildup up to this moment. And
exactly.
Yeah, Drezzo spent a lot of the time that first game hanging out, just him and his buddy Gray SMG, becoming fast friends. Even though you've got players literally all around him, I think he might have lifted his hands up and not touched keyboard.
It just said, you know what?
Just waited.
Just take the wheel.
But Noah, Nation, and Kinstar decide who's going to win this.
And again, right? Something to kind of talk about. Kinstar once again in a position where he was in the top four, top five. And like, you know, this time around was able to get the better of Ninja. So before we went to Justine, you actually did talk about whether or not Ninja is going to change his style going into it. You played with Ninja quite a bit as his friend.
Yeah. His style is usually to knock me off a mountain and laugh at me. That's typically his go-to in some way, shape, or form. Maybe send me on a rocket ride. And you're talking about against other people, not
yes,
teammates.
Not,
oh,
no,
my bad.
Exactly.
I get that confused quite often.
I understand. And sometimes, it can be a little traumatizing, I'm sure.
Yeah, I cry a lot about it. It's fine.
Just in bed at night. It's like, why? But I do want to know, though, like, we watch his stream. Everyone does. He's a very aggressive player. And I think that what ended up occurring there was he was playing around Marshmallow, but Marshmallow was supporting him very well, I would say. And I think in this next match, he's probably just going to have to go all for it, and Marshmallow is kind of just going to have to play that, play the backline game and support him a little bit more and just allow Ninja to go wild out there, because that's when he's at his prime.
So long as they move as one single unit, I think Ninja can get back into his aggressive play style, maybe take advantage of catching people off guard, because you have some really good players here. You have some very intimidating players to go against.
Yeah.
I mean, we've seen Joel McHale's an absolute monster, obviously. No, I'm kidding. There's a lot of opportunity here.
Exactly.
And things can get really crazy. So you don't know who might land a shot and who won't.
Yeah, and here's the thing. We actually talked about wanting to hear about what Ninja is going to be bringing to the table going into the big matchup coming up next. And we actually have Ninja over at the floor with Gloom. Take it away.
Here.
I'm here with Ninja right now, and he's very talented yet quiet friend Marshmallow. I would love a play-by-play of what just happened there.
Yeah, so me and Marsh rotated pretty early, which was what we wanted to do. We got into it on top of the mountain, took out a team, and then after that, all hell broke loose. We were in the best part of the map, so, and that's actually got lucky. That's where the circle was, and we had two teams come up from two different sides. Marsh got shot down, and obviously took massive fall damage. I thought he got thirsted at one point because I heard someone getting shotgunned, and I heard loot pop out. I thought it was him. It wasn't him. Anyways, he got, finished. Two more guys were above me. Another two guys were pushing up on, the north side. And then I had Courage was coming up with a grenade launcher. So I edited it out and killed him. And then I just 2v1, and I just kind of choked on a ramp build. And 28 HP was one shot. But hey, it's a warm-up for a reason, so.
Yeah, you guys were up. You guys were up on that hill. I was watching the map, and, everybody was coming for you guys. But, second place for the second match. This next match is the one that matters, and I have a feeling you guys are going to do pretty well.
Yeah, thank you. We're confident. We're comfortable. So,
well, thank you so much, Ninja. And back to you, Justine.
So as Gloom said, this match, it didn't really count. Just our pride. But that's it. Now $3 million tournament is coming up. Do you guys have any strategy? Are you guys going to change anything up at all?
I'll let my partner answer that one. I've been following his lead.
So I think the primary thing, I think me and Paul got a good understanding of how we want to rotate around the map, where we want to drop and stuff. So it's just about getting circle, and I think this next game will be a really good game for us.
So now the previous games, where did you guys place?
So the solo match, what did you place the solo match?
Solo, I was like 60s.
We don't
60s.
Have to talk about it. It's okay. Right.
So
it
the duo season. Match, I think right. We ended up getting, I want to say top 20.
We top 20 for yeah. sure.
So now going into this is going to be it. Have you guys ever played Fortnite outside before? Is this a different kind of thing?
This is a first. This is a first for me.
When they said that this was going to be outside, I'm like, how is this all going to work? But amazingly, it has. So what charities are you guys playing for? What are the charities that you guys are playing for?
What charities?
I have my own foundation that I'm playing for.
So we're going to be going to check out what is in the VIP package right now. Did you guys get to check that out at all?
I didn't. You know it's
VIP package?
No, I don't know.
Oh, you wait, because it's pretty exciting.
I picked St. Jude, though, by the way.
Well, we got something to look forward to, then.
We're going to see it right now. So let's throw to that and check it out.
Thanks, guys. Mooney and Zeke here to give you the rundown on what's in that VIP swag bag that all players at the Pro-Am will be going home with, but one of you lucky winners at home will also receive.
What's in the bag, Mooney?
Oh, okay. Well, Logitech has provided us with a G513 keyboard, a G903 mouse, the 4K webcam, the PowerPlay charging system, and on top of that, Astro coming in with that A40 headset.
That's not all. PlayStation is providing a custom Fortnite SCUF controller. This thing is crazy. And Xbox is delivering an Xbox One X, black and gold, that's gonna be customized with your gamer tag. On top of that, we have Fortnite socks, we have V-Buck cards to give away, the enamel pens, and that exclusive spray that you can only get for participating here. But how do you earn this stuff, Mooney?
All around the world you'll be able to win. This is a global sweepstakes. Just head over to our Twitter account, @FortniteGame. The pin tweet will have a blog with all of the details.
So if you guys are just tuning in, things are about to get started here. The huge tournament is about to start. But first, we have one more announcement for you. If you guys haven't found out yet, Fortnite is now on Nintendo Switch. Let's take a look at that trailer really quick.
So we're back here in the booth as we get ready for the big matchup, the matchup we're all waiting for. It's the $3 million charity match, $1 million going to the first place winner. And before we get into that, though, again, got to thank
the sponsors and the people who made this event happen. So thank you so much to them. You have AK Racing, Astro, Logitech G, Omen by HP, PlayStation, as well as Xbox. Thank you so much. And, you know, I got to give a huge shout out to Epic as well.
Absolutely.
For this amazing event. But that's not all, as a matter of fact. And, you know, as many of you may or may not know, I actually come from the world of esports.
Wait, what?
Yeah, yeah, you know, I've been doing this for, about a decade now, and, you know, it's something that's very, very close to my heart, and Epic knew that, and that's why we have a very, very special announcement. Let's take a look.
What's up, Fortnite fans? My name is KL Smith, and we have some big competitive news. You may have seen our previous blog announcing $100 million to fund Fortnite prize pools. Now, in less than a year, we've grown to 125 million players. And to celebrate the community and competitive play, we're pumped to announce the 2019 Fortnite World Cup. We'll be supporting community-run events, online events, and major competitions all over the world. Anyone can participate, and anyone can win. You will have a chance to grab a Fortnite World Cup spot by competing in official qualifiers around the globe. The $100 million prize money will be split between many events at all different levels of competition. Fortnite World Cup will focus on solos and duos, but there will be plenty of opportunities for you to squad up in competition too. This is for you, the players. Qualifying for the Fortnite World Cup will be based on merit, and Epic will not be selling teams or franchises, and we won't allow third-party leagues to do so either. Stay tuned, because rules, player code of conduct, and specifics about platforms and the initial schedule for fall 2018 are on the way. We can't wait to see the Fortnite competition heat up. Thank you for joining us on this journey. Now, everyone at the Pro-Am, back to you.
All right, there you have it, folks. The Fortnite World Cup is a thing. I'm so pumped.
That's huge.
I know.
It's huge. It's really cool to see Epic kind of embrace the competitive side of the game. And if it's just keep this in mind, too. If it's not part of the World Cup, it's probably not Epic sanctioned.
That's very, very well done, sir. Very well done. But now players are getting so serious for this next game here. Cassie, everyone's getting focused. They're getting ready to go. You know, we've been hoping to see these big battles, and we haven't been disappointed yet.
No, not at all, especially in the last few circles. Like, when the Tier 3 Storms and Forwards start coming in, like, it heats up.
Yeah.
It really heats up.
It really does.
Imagine a situation, 1v1, it comes down to the very last engagement. Mm-hmm. Somebody impulse nades, flies at the other opponent, misses, takes fall damage. How do you feel in that moment? What if it was you?
Oh. Well, for one, I would know that I'm at very least I'm going to get a substantial amount of cash for my charity
still
choice. So that's okay, because it's, you know, it's for the charities. But still, oh, look at Jeanine.
That's a spicy look.
But here's the thing. If that moment happens, it will be one of the most hype moments you could possibly, she agrees, ever have. There's Allie.
But, Sniper Wolf, hello.
And the players are getting ready. Match up. There's King Richard right there.
I expect big plays from him yet again. The solo game, he was putting on a show. He's got to do it again. He has to.
You know, I'm a little
eyebrows. Young man, you need to calm down.
I would say I'm a little disappointed. I was hoping to see Myth kind of shock us a bit more.
Disappointed in Myth?
I know. You know.
You're going to see this on Twitter. You realize that, right?
He's my boy. I love him.
Don't associate me with any memes that are generated from this, please.
He's my boy. I love him to death. But you know what, man? He holds himself to a higher standard, and I think we're going to get it in this next game. I think we are. Any other players, Cassie, that you are looking for to perform here?
I'm really looking forward to watching Cypher play. He just plays at such an incredibly high level. I want to see him get some edit.
Yeah.
Elimination, some traps down.
Oh, he just hit him. Oh, that's
disrespectful. This man is getting
He doesn't even know him.
And he's dabbing.
Do not condone pickaxe violence. Know that. That is the most serious look I think I've seen yet.
Jeanine is just...
She wants some.
Ready.
It's just so much anger. You know, I guess that's what you need. You got to get ready. Got to get ready for the matchup here. That's what they're playing for as well. That's the trophy. You can see it. In the sight, that is a sick trophy.
Now as the battle bus gets ready to fly in.
There it is.
You're here live. Can I get some noise?
Let's go, guys.
Let's go.
This is the big one.
Yeah.
It's all for the cash now.
There we go. a mess of players jumping out very early.
Sea of humanity.
Now you can see even Murderbeat's Nashat looking really far north. You can see a really good spread of players across the entire map, I think, for this, because this is the match. You even see, look, the far west side of the map, you have players doing the drop right over the edge, right over the water, trying to swoop in and get as low as they can. They're trying to play around Snobby Shores, maybe the expected empty zones, which I think people might be a little disappointed.
Gotta get low, gotta get that gun first. You don't want to have a, you don't want it to not go your way in the beginning of the game.
Now you never know. I mean, we watched earlier, players like Nick Merckx can drop in on no gun, get something, and still make it out alive.
If you can aim well with a burst, you are good.
Yeah, and if you're able to shred with that one, that is going to get you out of a pickle without a doubt. Hey, you know what? I'm a fan of that green suppress SMG. It's okay. Use it. Willard, use it to your heart's content.
They're digging in retail, home and native land, ready to rock. Now, the basketball house, very close. We've discussed many times on my stream that the price of that house it's got to be the most expensive one there.
It's got a treasure chest spread. In the doghouse.
It's kind of nice. Yeah, look. Nobody knows, but Loot Lake, Dusty Divot, and Anarchy Acres completely, even Pleasant Park. Look at this north side. What are you guys doing? Go for some loot.
I'm expecting Courage Joe to rotate Pleasant Park, but the fact that no one is there.
That looks
no
like
one went to Anarchy.
Me.
There's tumbleweed just flying by.
This is just nothing. Very nothing. Wild west out there. That being said, it looks like the edge, the entire outside of the circle is going to be active. I don't think I've seen this many players in Risky Reels and Wailing Woods ever. But Jack and One Shot Girl getting established and Lucky Landing. We've got Rich, JT Brown, Dylan Francis
actually
knocked down already.
This is really bad.
Dylan and Jericho wearing matching outfits, but not making matching plays right now because we got one left out to drive.
Jericho has absolutely no resources to work with here, and that is going to do it.
Rich and JT capitalizing, claiming Risky Reels.
At least they look good.
They have time to watch a movie now, too, man.
You know, I like how they went risky for this important game because it is risky. It's risky out there. It really
dad
is.
Jokes. Oh, well,
you're so funny, Cassie.
No, it is, though. It's very open. There's guns everywhere.
And
it's
you can also make that rotation to Anarchy if you want, right?
Dude, that is true.
Serious face. I've never seen someone so serious about looting in my life.
Just really focused. This is very focused looting. Got to hit those circles. But I was going to say, you can make those rotations happen over to Anarchy if you want, right? There is some loot that can be grabbed there. But there's really not enough wood in that area, which is, I guess, what you want early on in the game.
That's, what is Tim doing?
Tim, now's not the time.
Tim.
Tomato Man, what are you doing? All right, he's got his pickaxe back out.
Tim, not the time to be a bot, Tim.
Tim, gargoyling is bad. Please, there we go, brother. Okay, we're back.
He's on his way.
Oh, wait.
Oh, no. Oh, okay.
I just hope he just gets sniped. That's all I can hope for, right?
Mellow J moving out here. We have all the way west side. I was saying earlier, this was right underneath where the bus was going, which
Jeffrey sees.
Oh.
It's actually got Noah J in front, and Frizz is already out of here, so it's going to be Jeffrey.
All right, Jeff.
What
Blue
you got?
Tack.
Come on, Jeff.
Ray pistol, two minis.
One goal, one desire.
Honestly, I think at this point I'd probably run the heck away.
Yeah, there's really just not
a Madeline or build up there. I mean, too good of a spot.
A blue pump and a green.
You know what?
Attack.
Look at this.
Here.
Jeff is a gamer. Push in, brother. You got this. Well, maybe next time.
I'm glad that you were just motivating. You know, you were motivating.
That's what I'm here for.
Oh, but it is going to be short work there for Jeffrey and Frizz as they are going to be out of the money in this matchup. But Snobby will go to Madeline and Noah J.
Noah's been putting on a pretty good show so far while over the course of these three games. Now, they're established here in Snobby, but that doesn't mean they're out of the hot water yet. There are a couple players you can't see right now, but there's a couple players to the north and northeast. Courage and Kenneth are split right now, which is kind of strange. But they're going to have to move into the circle straight east, and Frags is there. They're at the gas station. They have an opportunity to kind of gatekeep a little bit, and that's not even the beginning of it. It looks like a Greasy Grove. Potentially we can cut down there super quick. Greasy Grove has some action going on.
There are a lot of bodies over by Greasy
the
Grove.
The northeast corner there. All right, we're kind of in the same area. Darkness taking out Isaac. Live in the feed there. Jack and One Shot Girl looking down on
Joe McHale's out. So
Cypher took him out. Now, Joel was in the far northeast corner. Lyric was hanging out inside the factories. There's a dance club there. You think Lyric has an opportunity to go and drop some moves?
I hope so.
You know, before they keep playing?
I'm a fan of it. Why not?
Go to dance emote.
You have time. Oh, go to dance. Oh, well.
I gotta go with the old school default, man.
Bro, everybody knows Orange Justice is what
or actually Orange Justice. Okay. Rambunctious, the new one. I like that one. That's come on, that's just a gift. That's not even fair.
Do you think One Shot Girl called Epic and activated streamer perks?
I think
that's
so.
A thing, isn't it?
I think
probably.
So. She had the app on her phone. She just pulled it up.
Mac and Tim moving out across these fields, looking for somewhere to settle down. You know,
it looks
build
like Cypher's gonna get into a fight pretty soon with King Richard. Here's some action.
Ninja's right above him.
John and two tap.
You have to be an excellent player. So this 1v1 situation, you're not necessarily the best. Marshmallow's got an angle to the side, so kind of support, gets the drop there. Going to force him to build up a little 1v1, and Ninja now has his eyes on the target. He's just going to shoot out that top. He's going to try and do the edit replace maneuver, potentially. It's where you shoot out a surface, immediately place your
there
own.
Goes the remote.
The C4.
The remote explosives.
He's making a push
in.
He's lobbing your brother.
He's lobbing
him. Watch out.
Doing a lot of damage there. Player's actually going to be stuck behind this wall. That, oh, man. Oh, no.
Oh,
the disrespect.
Bad.
12 shotgun shots
risky,
later.
Risky. You don't want to do that, Lupo. Not bust out the pickaxe and go for the
memes,
disrespect.
Go
for memes, man.
See you on YouTube.
I can't believe it.
Looks like we have the Tomato Man to the Tap Man building up, trying to wall off against his opponents. Watch the fall damage, bud. He's going to build up, try and get the height advantage now. It's Tim versus Smith. Max down. One.
Oh, good night, Tim.
Oh, you didn't know what you were up against, Tim. It's okay. We forgive you.
We forgive you. But that is going to do it for Tim the Tap Man and his teammate. Now, Myth and Paul George, you spoke with them at Justine, I believe, spoke with them earlier. And I think they're just focusing up, getting ready. We also have another engagement that's going to be going on over here as well.
A whole bunch of fall damage there, kind of putting herself in a bad spot, a 1v1.
Femstuff doesn't have anything to really give herself that health advantage in this fight, despite the fall damage, though, right? It's very flimsy. You can just get absolutely shredded here if you're not careful.
All you need is a blue pump. Trust me. She's going to watch. She's going to push out. She's going to put some crazy moves on. They're sitting in a campfire. Maybe now's the time to push. She doesn't know that, though, so I forgive her. Yeah, they're making some more telling campfire stories. And okay. Things lose fruit. Maxed out.
Things just took a turn. Things took a turn for the worst, to say the least.
Prepare your F keys to pay respects, please. Femstuff, you got to make some big plays here.
Yeah, this is going to be tough. We can't sugarcoat it. We got to call it down the line. Femstuff is in a really difficult position as it currently stands. You can't. You simply just cannot contend with all of this health that's going to be coming from Backpack Kid and Loserfruit.
Gloom, 1v2 situation, low ammo count. What do you do? You're stuck inside a house. You have opponents above you.
Honestly, I don't know if they heard Femstuff. Femstuff is being very, very quiet.
Sneaky, sneaky.
Very sneaky.
Okay, my option would probably be to C4 the ground and take myself.
If I'm going
out, it's on my own terms.
That's right, man. You push forward. Do what you got to do. Loserfruit actually ends up, I think it was a knockdown. I just saw it pop up on the screen ever so briefly.
That Femstuff is still in there.
Maybe not, but
Josh, you are the most chill player I've ever. He's just
hanging out.
Top. And Pokey just hanging out on top of this little
Yeah, they just built a nice little house. They got some nice range.
It's beautiful.
A scoped AR and a nice bolt.
Myth kind of bouncing in and out of your range. That's why the nameplate's disappearing, which means he might be moving away there. They don't necessarily have an opportunity to push. But they don't really have to. They do need to worry about the zone. They got 2 minutes, 5 seconds till the circle closes. And look at this ring. Look at all the players right on the edge. You're going to see a lot of people get cut off by the storm here. You have fighting going on in Tilted right now.
Mm-hmm.
You have a
Nick
bunch
Merckx?
Of teams even down in the south.
Of course, he's
Nick
in Tilted.
In Tilted.
Shout out to Nick Merckx for always going Tilted. I don't think he knows anywhere. Has he been anywhere else?
No, I don't actually think he knows that there are any other locations in the map. Just Tilted. That's the only
Nick,
place.
Nick, other places you got to spread out, brother.
I like his style. Yeah. I respect it.
You don't really come off as an individual who would be an aggressive player, but you're a little bloodthirsty, which I respect that.
Artie and Dredd stuck in a bad spot. Yuzo and Liam have the grenades going in, just going to drop the structure out. You leave them exposed and then just AR tap fire. Mike seals the deal here. There you go.
That's white damage too, so
yeah,
no shield for that player. Musev now on the move.
He's serious.
Looking
Look at that face.
Look at the Dredd's playing defense with that wall, trying to protect, but Dredd is going to go down.
Artie, I need you to get out there. Oh, okay, you don't have to worry about your teammate now. I take that back. Don't worry about your teammate anymore. I think it might be too late for him.
Go on without me. Remember me. I believe. Artie and the house, I mean.
They're just watching. Right. And I don't blame him. Right now, Muzok and Liam, they don't need to get aggressive. Artie's stuck in the building. He's going to make a move, it looks like, out the back, potentially. Muzok has an opportunity to look down in, take a couple shots, maybe, but he's backing out.
Oh, another elimination just came through.
With Paul George.
And this is the duo that we've been looking out for. this whole time. Inaka, though.
Josh.
Laying down some fire. Oh, man. Josh is out of this one.
Josh, don't blame yourself. You were pinched. It's okay. We all forgive you.
It's really not much he could have done in that particular situation, but Tenshin and Inaka hanging out here. And it really just, you know, you had to be very careful, like, when they poke out and just take that damage, right? When they peek over that ledge, take the shot, then back away. Those are the kinds of things you just have to be very cautious for. You can't stay there for too long and just try and take some pot shots, because they will punish you for that.
Now, if we're looking at the winner of the duo's warm-up, Kinstar and his teammate Sean. Sean, I saw on the feed, got eliminated. I'm trying to locate.
One shot girl's out as well.
So we're cutting out some of the players that we kind of had our eyes on, right, from previous gameplay. Things have changed up. I think that's the nature of Fortnite. Kinstar. So Kinstar could bring home the W all on his own.
That's going to be some fall damage, as a matter of fact, that Kinstar ended up taking. Courage is going right for it. Courage is right in his face. And it seems like Courage might be eliminates Kinstar. Takes out Sean.
It's too bad. Courage has been playing extremely well. Minus the fact that he's sat a lot of time at Pleasant Park. Okay, I get it. Courage, you're a little scared.
Well, it beats okay. Ninja and Marshmallow. They're on that hill again.
No, look at this. This is what I was expecting. Ninja is a really intelligent player. He's going to play for position because he's going for the win. It's for charity. The winner gets $1 million towards the charity of their choice, and that is huge. So playing for the W that's all that matters, right?
I just hope they don't get pinched up there.
Build up high.
Yeah, that's
real high.
And a lot of fortification.
In myth-like fashion.
Ninja's going to have to channel his inner myth, build high, lots of fortification.
Backpack Kid, Lucifer drops some beats in the base in Salty Springs. This is one of the newer structures. They're all the way down to the bottom. And they're just partying, man. They just want to hang out. Look at this. Look at this.
I wonder if they think they're all. There you go.
That was
how are you going to cut away from that?
Backpack Kid literally doing the dance, and you cut away. Unbelievable. Lucifer, Backpack Kid, dance at the bottom. Wait, Prince Royce and Willy Rex might have heard that being above.
Oh, yeah, definitely. I mean, I think that they just set the...
No, they're rolling away.
Never mind.
It was
enjoy your day. It's your base now. Nick Merck's dropping Nate's shot. The elimination in the feed there. The Naka taking out Liam.
Fellow 100 Thieves member. And so, wow. You know.
Wow. There's going to be drama in that Discord
drama
later.
Lots of drama.
Name calling.
Jordan. King Richard's all the way going to be up top as well.
Jordan's picking up Stone Mountain, I think, down at the bottom of the base there. But Rich, Valkyrie, maybe potentially going to run into each other. Rich is sitting up top. He's got that hunting rifle out. Taking shots at Murder Beats and misses. Better luck next time.
We haven't seen any crazy shots today, like crazy snipe shots. I'm a little disappointed. A little sad.
Stone Mountain has that purple the orange AR running out there. Just got revived. Yuzov trying to put himself in a height advantage just to take shots down on his bonies. They're running away.
Moosehill took those shots, and that's actually going to pop the
shield. Wow, what a set of shots.
And that was an instant elimination, so that means that they are out of here.
That was with a gray AR, by the way.
Yeah.
For anybody keeping track at home, that is the worst AR.
And I believe...
Doggy Ray is getting some very long-range snipes. Took Pete Wentz out.
Is she
124
really?
Meters.
Okay.
All right, Ali, build up. Produce a YouTube video for me that I will not believe, please.
Yes. I do not want to believe what you are going to give right now. Allie, I
want to
be absolutely stunned, because what we might find will surprise us.
I can't
believe
Epic
did this. And that is also going
to
Twitter. Well done.
I can't believe Epic did this. Allie, still in this match.
You've got Chandler Riggs and Kitty Plays that are playing very outside the zone. Allie here, he's just hanging out in this doodle. Here we go.
I wonder if Allie knows that there are people around him. I don't think.
Probably not.
I don't think so.
You think he's spending a lot of time just trying to figure out what to do for
he's
the
just trying
nail
to stun out here, you know?
Video?
Yeah.
How many yellow arrows can you fit in one thumb? I'm just kidding. And then I will also see that on Twitter. Looking forward to that later as well.
All right. So as the storm begins to converge here, we're down to 29 players left in this game. $3 million on the line for charity. And Allie is positioned himself nicely. He does have some eyes up there with that green AR. I mean, you can potentially take some shots, but I really wouldn't. I wouldn't do that in this instance. Okay. Or you just dance. I think he heard his name and just was like, you know, I'm just gonna dance.
I don't blame him. Now, he's in an interesting position because if there's players at the top of any of these structures and he hugs too far away, any of the walls, if he's too close to any of the edges, they might have an angle with a snipe shot, and that might be the end of it, you know? Courage, Kenneth, hanging out the top of their metal tower. If you noticed, Ninja and Marshmallow were in a wood tower. The option, the choice to for different materials, why do you think that is? Because I feel like a metal tower, if they've been sitting in there roasting marshmallows, sorry, bud, that long, I mean, what's why?
The strategy there, I mean, I think is very clear, right? You know, they were able to fully generate the metal on that one, so it's going to take a lot of shots to be able to take that down. Courage, though, gets the float onto Jordan, and now there was the damage, though, did come for Kenneth, and Kenneth has to pop those minis and get back into a position where he had 100 shields there, but did not expect that shot. So that's why they ended up putting, you know, that as I like to call the backboard right there, to just give them a little bit of cover as they look to engage on any players. Ninja and Courage just right next to one another, and I'm worried for Ninja because the wood, it's very flimsy. It's not like metal casting.
It is a little bit more flimsy, and Courage is a force to be reckoned with that grenade launcher.
Really is. You don't necessarily need to talk about Ninja's wood materials on the broadcast like that. I understand, though. Yeah, you probably should have gone with a shot. Long-range shot there. Lucifer going for the montage.
Going for it.
The fight was decided before she could interject, though.
And Ninja eliminate. Actually, that was a... Wait a minute. Was that Myth and the crew? I have to actually... I'm actually stunned if that is actually the case here, because...
I'm not seeing Myth on the map anymore, my friend.
Things might have
just gone south for TSM boys.
That's rough. That is rough. Myth and Paul George are out.
Valkyrie currently shooting at Loserfruit. Murda Beats, he's upset. They're shooting like mad over there.
Just going, just taking shots. Seeing if they could bait anyone out, right? Put it, because sometimes too, right? You know, if they do have the coordination, they could, you know, like, for example, Marshmallow can like peek over, put some shots out, and then the player can poke out whoever's going to try and challenge, and Ninja can actually go for that snipe. And now there's going to be a fight going on. Valkyrie is, going to be down and out. That is going to do it. Loserfruit and Backpack Kids still very much in this game.
I mean, there's a benefit to hiding in the bottom of a building that's like three stories deep, okay? No one's really going to look at you. Now, there's a ton of other fighting going on. It looks like while there are other engagements, you have an opportunity, Backpack Kid and Loserfruit, to just kind of clean up all the loot. You see upgrading from greens to blues, picking up all the healing you can. You have a little bit of C4 left, and they have ammo like crazy. So they're in a really good spot, minus the lack of HP from that last fight. Valkyrie tried to take him out as best she could. The TAC shotgun looks like it might have failed her, though, which is too bad.
Also, another thing I want to point out here, Nick Merckx, the northern part of this map, still
been hanging out.
Yeah, still fighting. Still keeping it alive for the MFAM here, but it's going to be very tough. Tall order indeed.
Chandler Kitty plays. They've been hanging out on the west side of the circle pretty consistently, not trying to avoid engagements. This is definitely two players that are going for the win. They're not trying to get overly aggressive. A little trading and healing there. Courage and Kenneth, top of the hill. They're going to try and defend against any push from outside the zone. I referred to this earlier as gatekeeping. Look at the look of determination on this Optic player's face as he's got eyes. He's got a bead on the next target, and they kind of have zone advantage. Gloom, let's say he drops this.
Oh, 50 damage. That's white damage as well. This is bad.
This is very bad.
Oh, Kyla, what a play. That is just a crazy blast.
I've spotted bad guys.
Uncle Jack.
Wow.
Doing it.
I've seen more BM from players in this charity event than I think I've ever seen any. This is ridiculous. A lot of friendships ending. It feels like Mario Party out here.
It's supposed to be a celebration of Fortnite. Instead, it's just Salt City.
Why can't we be friends?
You have a very angelic voice.
Stop it. Kitty plays Chandler. They're kind of in the bottom of the mix here. They've got a lot. They have a lot of people above him. Ninja trying to take a shot. He's got that gold scoped.
And they've committed. They've committed to this location, Lupo. I mean,
have they even they've moved there from there yet? They've been there long enough that I think they own the house that they built.
I'm a little worried because Ali A has a very good shot on them. I just hope they don't gargoyle and get a little bit too distracted.
Oh boy!
Marshmallow going for the snipes as well. Look at these boys. You can very much tell that Marshmallow and Ninja have played together quite a bit because they have a very similar play style, which is almost terrifying. Because
they're going aggressive.
See? They're just going to start pushing. They're trying to mix it up, go for big plays.
He's got to be careful. Marshmallow at this point in time just trying to support. The nades are coming in, though. Oh, boy, Prince Royce. This is going to be rough. Just running away from this one wisely
Bandages
enough.
Bandages in hand.
I don't blame him, man. If you had grenades coming in potentially from Ninja and Marshmallow, wouldn't you run? I feel like I'm already running.
And also just look at Courage and you know, I mean, really, Courage and Kenneth just continuing to have that upper hand. I mean, the circle gods have been in their favor, but Ali 8 just eliminated Loser Fruit there.
Number of players remaining. Declining. The shots coming out. Courage.
Look at that. Look at that fire there.
Their
the coordination.
Literally, they're firing at two different opponents at the same time. Unafraid.
I think
you might want to look out because Ninja's dropping some grenades in there, boys.
Everyone just realized that you got to look at the giant metal tower that's in the nice spot.
Oh, yeah, that's up there. Maybe we should do something
about
it.
Maybe we should handle the business, but as a matter of fact, the nade launch comes through.
Uh-oh.
Courage throws down. He only has one. He takes out Marshmallow.
Oh, down.
Courage takes on Marshmallow.
10 players left.
Okay. I'm going to build back up to you, get bandages, okay?
The coordination there. Kitty
Chandler.
Kitty's watching her teammate just tick out. I'm just kidding. She would never do that. She's a great person.
Just looking
okay.
out for number one.
Scoop Chandler up off the ground and get back to it. Ninja picking up Marshmallow. Looks like we're coming down to the very end here. Prince Royce, Willy Rex are still in it. Stone Mountain's still alive. We haven't seen him in quite a while.
Very true.
Ali-A getting the shotgun. Willy Rex,
these guys have no
Royce
choice. They got to go in.
With Courage and Kenneth.
Yeah, they have to push because they have 35 seconds remaining. So they just want to be able to establish any kind of control and as well as get resources.
That fire will help for sure.
They are very low on resources right now.
Topping
guys.
Off the HP, like you were saying. The campfire is going to be crucial here. But I feel like if you're in a position where you can just kind of poke in on some of these fights, maybe topping off that last, like, 20 HP isn't the best bet. We'll see. We'll see. Kitty plays Chandler going to start making some moves here. Yeah, was it worth it?
We'll see.
That is the question. Kenneth, though, goes back for the poke. Kitty backing away. Doesn't have any heals. And then you also – or any shields. And then you also – have shots coming down, forcing Kitty to have to disengage. Storm now is going to start to come in here, and things are getting very tight as the players are just starting to converge on one another. And just look at what we have.
You have Ninja and Marshmallow in a cubby hole. Just
letting
below
it happen.
Courage
with another
lasering
one.
Lasering Chandler down.
I believe that's five eliminations right now for Uncle Jack.
Ali-A going down. You've got
that's six. Oh, Ali-A believes it all right.
Death from above.
And they've just, I mean, this has been their game plan this entire time. Just look at this Courage.
Love it. He has incredible accuracy. Just lasering in there. Kenneth getting the, I believe, a knockdown in there or a limit. He may have finished a kill.
So Kitty now, you know, being down low like this, and, you know, one has to wonder, you have to be very worried for Kitty. But still, though, the players that everyone's looking at, two teammates formerly, you know, in the last competition that they played in, now going up against one another here. Ninja, Marshmallow.
Now, you could see there Ninja had the little blueprints out. He was using the edit to look through, and Courage and Kenneth are above. Ninja's going to try and watch them from underneath. I think they might start putting down the pyramids, just try and play defensive, build up a layer here, something they can sit on top of. And I think Courage don't realize Ninja and Marshmallow are just hanging out in there.
Yeah.
They're just chilling.
This is, and I think
they're going to make a push on Kitty potentially.
Yeah, I think they just want to sweep this one through. And Kitty, I mean, she just knows that this is a rough spot. And here it goes. The storm's pushing in.
That's a jump pad from Ninja. They're trying to make a play from above. Marshmallow's hanging on the back.
He's hanging back. He's just going to provide support, but Courage is going to go up onto Ninja. Courage is taking damage. Ninja, though, might be able to make this one happen and go over to Kitty.
Unbelievable gameplay. There we go. We're back at Courage Kenneth trying to hack their way out.
He doesn't have any shields.
The top down Ninja got the advantage. He pushed up.
Kenneth is down.
Marshmallow gets the knockdown to Kenneth. We got a 1v2.
That's it.
Woo!
Ninja and Marshmallow. You have Kitty plays as well.
Courage is still up.
Courage is still alive. The crowd's going for Ninja. Courage is trying to make a play happen. He doesn't really have much to work with here. $1 million for your charity on the line. And right now, Ninja and Marshmallow, they have the power position. They have the high ground. They have the control.
You think this comes down to a campfire offense you can start? Courage has half a hit point.
I don't know.
If a butterfly hits him, he gets eliminated.
I don't know if Courage has anything to work with. And then Kitty, I mean, she's going to have to make a move eventually. This game is essentially Ninja and Marshmallow's to win. This is their game to win.
Ninja completely turned it around here.
They were stuck in that cubbyhole, and they pushed their way out just the right time.
They let Courage and Kenneth do the work for them.
How much of the work do you think that they did?
All the work, baby.
All the work.
All the work.
All the work. All right, gentlemen. You're set up. You're ready to go. Looks like Kitty's trying to take advantage of potentially.
I think that's Courage. Oh. Yeah, yeah, Courage gets it.
Good night.
Kitty off guard. Oh, the look of frustration.
Yeah, look of frustration, but now Courage.
Courage with 7 HP in a dream.
He doesn't have anything to work with. He knows that he's basically in a terrible spot, and that is basically.
Ooh, that is a small circle.
It's not over yet, though, folks. Make some noise for Courage. See if he can bring it back. Let's go.
Yeah, I mean, at this point now, if you're part of the Courageous, you got to believe. You have to believe. But he is in such a bad spot.
A look of pure fear. He's taking shots. Ninja.
All he has to do is breathe on him, and he's going to get the win.
Ah!
And that's going to do it. Ninja gets the win.
Let's go!
$1 million for charity here at the Fortnite Pro-Am. Him and Marshmello come out on top. Wow. What a game. But what a performance from Courage as well.
Unbelievable. The last couple circles were so tense. I'm impressed by the fact that Ninja was able to capitalize on remaining hidden. They sat in a box and just bandaged up, licked their wounds, and waited for just the right time to come out.
They played it so intelligently there, Cassie.
I need to, I mean, you've played with Ninja a lot. How do you turn that around? You're hiding.
I'm pretty sure he hacks.
It was just tactical waiting, okay?
Tactical waiting.
Well, that's what Marshmello did
strategy.
Too. Marshmello did that as well. He sat there, he waited, and then he shot a guy in the back of the head.
And he just supported his teammate, and then Ninja went in for it. But Courage also, he was in a really bad spot, but still, though, what a performance, a fill-in here for the Pro-Am at the last minute. Uncle Jack doing the work, but it's this man right here, Ninja, and his partner Marshmello, who get the victory. Let's actually send it over to Justine.
I am here with our duo's winner, Ninja and Marshmello. Guys, congratulations.
Thank you so much. This is amazing. Just super pumped. Oh, my God.
I mean, this came down to the last second. Yeah. And you know what's incredible is watching you guys play here in real life. I mean, you guys are watching it online, but there's so much energy here in the stadium.
Yeah, you can just feel it. Like, after every single fight, you hear one massive shotgun blast, and the entire crowd just freaking out, losing their minds, because, like, it's just so intense. It's way more, obviously, epic IRL than it is, you know, online. It's amazing.
Really, it's crazy. So, you guys, I feel like you worked really well together. I just thought maybe, you know, I had to try.
Yeah. He said that we've been putting in a lot of work and a lot of practice, and Marsh is just happy that, you know, I think he promised a couple of people that he was going to win, and we brought it home. So.
And you definitely did. And I think the biggest question that we had here, I hate to bring it up, but how are you able to see under there? Do you want to relay? Maybe.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Okay. I already know I was able to. So he actually has like super vision, like really good vision. So we just bumped up the brightness on his monitor, and he was able to just, like, I mean, he actually did a really good job. He was shooting out everyone when they were building up, and that was our strategy going into it, so.
It was really impressive. Congratulations, guys. We're going to throw it back up to the casters.
And it was on this day that a human and a snack food were able to get the victory. Congratulations to Ninja and Marshmello. And again, I got to give Marshmello just all the credit in the world. Jokes aside, homie's playing in a mask.
There's no way I could do it. There's absolutely no way I could do it.
Oh, man.
You realize that by playing in a mask and winning a charity event like this, I think our careers are over yet again. This is the end, dude. Yes. This is it.
That's the new meta. Wear a mask, win $1 million for charity. But here are the final moments of that game. And again, it really came down to the really uncomfortable situation that Courage found himself in. Still tried to make the best out of a bad situation, though, after taking out Kitty Place.
He went for what he could. 7 eliminations over the course of the game. They were playing out of their minds for majority of it. But like you said, an unlucky finish there. And just a little heel off here. Ninja, Marshmello, both just chilling up top as Courage started to bomb grenades up. See if he can get him to drop down, get into an engagement, take advantage of maybe just a bad angle or some missed aim. And that's not how things played out.
Yeah, Courage knew, but he did his absolute best in that situation. And what a conclusion to that game. Congratulations to Ninja and Marshmello on their victory yet again. And I mean, what a blast that was to cast, man.
That was fantastic.
I cast many games, man, but that was one of the most intense situations I've seen. And the crowd was chanting Ninja's name. Everyone was going like insane at that very last moment.
Oh, yeah.
Look at that. Oh, wow. So, I mean, I think, you know, kind of looking back on it, though, right, everyone, just so much credit it needs to be given to the celebrities who stepped up, right? You know, a lot of these guys, they have very busy lives, but yet they still play Fortnite as much as they possibly can. And then they're out there. I even heard, like, a lot of them met up with their – there's Ninja again. But a lot of them have met up and played online with their partner to get ready for this game. Everyone was taking this very, very seriously.
Ninja and Marshmallow, I think, training their whole lives for this moment. Everything leading up to the it was really cool to see the build up to this on people's streams, on YouTube, videos and stuff like that of these people collaborating. And like I've said in the past, I'll say it again, Fortnite has this ability to push its way out in such a good way and bring positivity. This is all for charity. And a number of, you know, a bunch of content creators have done charity events, Fortnite related in the past. It's great. It's wonderful to see.
That's right. Well, let's take a look at the final standing. So coming in 10th place, you had Loser Fruit as well as Russell, who was able to get $30,000 for their charity, Samara Redway, as well as Cyrus Spencer, 40 grand, Patriota, Kyla Drew, 50 grand. Gold Glove and Whit Lowry was able to get 60. Willy Rex, Prince Roy, 70K. You also had Ali A and Pete Wentz. Ali A went all the way, got three eliminations there, 80 grand for his charity. Then Stone Mountain, 64, and Jordan Fisher were able to get some money for their charity as well. And then, you guys know the rest. You read the graphic. You know who won the game.
I commend Courage for securing the second place. You have to remember, too, everybody that placed on that board right there that was on your screen a second ago, they all earned money for charity. Wow. Every single penny counts. And so I have to commend everybody for all their work.
It was awesome stuff here for us, and it was an incredible matchup for us to call. Thank you so much to the Fortnite community. But let's actually send it over to Gloom right now, who has a player standing by.
I'm here with Courage and Kenneth. You guys did so amazing. Despite the fact that you came in second, you got the most limbs. How does that feel?
I'm super proud of Kenneth. From just playing, and I didn't even know I was participating in this 24 hours ago. Now to be here kind of as a fill-in, we immediately got that chemistry down. We were laughing. Not only did we just do well, but I'm super happy that we were having a good time playing Fortnite. This man's a beast. We worked so well together, and we came out in second. We only lost to Ninja today.
I saw that you subbed in for Summit, and like you're such an incredible player. Been watching your stream over the past few months. You're just absolutely insane. And Kenneth, you're such a great teammate. I can't believe it. $500,000 in second place. So it's not like losing was. It's not like losing hurts. Still a lot of money.
I mean, losing don't hurt too much when you put it that way. I mean, but still, to play second in this type of event, this type of atmosphere, these type of player, it's just amazing. I had a great partner. Me and Courage just really went out there and had a good time. We enjoyed ourselves, and I think we want to come back next year and get Ninja and Marshmallow. We owe them.
That's a given. We'll be back next time for revenge, Ninja and Marshmallow. You just wait.
Well, thank you guys so much for the time, and back to Justine to close it out.
We are down here with our Pro-Am 2018 Fortnite winners. We've got Ninja and Marshmallow. Congratulations.
Thank you so much. This is so amazing.
Now, going into this, did you think you guys were going to win? I mean, I know everybody was betting on it.
No, we knew. Never going to say we knew we were going to win, but like we knew we had a good shot. All of Marshmallow's management was like, he's playing more Fortnite than he is making music. Like, you guys should probably do well. And we had a couple games of practice, like a couple hours of practice before, and we knew what we wanted to do, and we just stuck to it, and it worked out.
Well, I think that's a good problem to have, and clearly it has worked out. Absolutely. But now we need to give you guys the prizes here. We've got the Golden Pickaxes, Golden Boy, Dr. Lupo. And here you have it, guys, the 2018 Pro-Am Fortnite Tournament winners. Congratulations, guys.
Thank you so much.
We're going to be heading up to the Founders Club now to see what else we have. There's more gameplay to be had. See you guys soon.
that is it?
In all honesty, it's been a wild day. Ninja taking it home. Kinstar with that duos win. And the solo win coming out of Noah. You know, it's been a ride, and I'm out here with Gubba. I'm over here with Pookieface. Gubba, how'd you enjoy the Pro-Am?
It was amazing. It was awesome.
Amazing and awesome. That's two adjectives, folks. Pookie, what are your thoughts?
I thought it was pretty good. Pretty happy with how my boy Myth did, so.
Myth holding it down for sure. Ninja taking it out on top. You know, I had a lot of folks when I was doing those interviews in line. There was a lot of Ninja fans, a lot of Myth fans. Ninja pulling it out, really keeping those dreams alive. But we're getting some games in here, just hanging out in the lounge. Our first game, though, Gubba, a sole survivor here, roaming around the map alone. Zero kills, but I have faith in you, Gubba. I got faith.
She's going to carry our team to victory.
It's a good thing, yeah, no. So, like, hopping in here, I think we just need to wrap up this last match with Gubba. We'll see if she can grab a kill here.
We all died because Gubba.
Honestly,
said
Zeke,
lucky
I want
landing.
Some of your opinions over here.
Listen, we said lucky landing, okay?
Lucky
okay.
landing.
Pookie
Zeke, I don't think the folks can hear you at
lady.
Home.
Jump.
Do you want to get on this mic here?
Here, let me try that mic. Okay, so basically what happened was, ladies and gentlemen at home, we decided lucky landing, okay? We're like, we're going to go to lucky. Pookie's like, sick, jumps out. I'm like, sick, jump out. We both mark map. Gubba's like, listen, I'm better than you. You guys go off and die. Okay, I'm going to land Dusty Divot. I'm going to go get a W. She's over there waving. Now we just wait, ladies and gentlemen. We're going to watch and wait as Gubba TV, no skin, makes her way to the number one Victory Royale spot. Mooney, over to you.
I think that's actually her middle name, Gubba No Skin TV. I believe that is correct. Please confirm that.
Yeah, it is correct. Everybody's going to underestimate me.
You never know what's coming with the no skin. You never know what die you're rolling. You never know what's going on. There's no—I don't think there's a Skull Trooper in here. I saw Zeke pulling that out earlier. That's his signature skin. That's true. We all know that. And in all honesty, it's been a little bit of a wild ride, I think, with all this stuff. Like, Musical.ly trying to pull off the shopping cart play earlier. We're really trying to pull off the similar plays here. We're just trying to show up to that level. Honestly, if I can play up to that, I'd be surprising a lot of folks at home. And, God, it's a tense one here as Gubba looks for an enemy on the horizon. They're just staying away from her. They know the no skin. They know. See, you know what? The way we play no skin is no skin, no fear. So you just get in the combat, get into the thick of things, rocking the gray pistol and gray tack. Gray pistol, gray tack, ladies and gentlemen. Pookie, what do you got to say about that brave strategy?
Gray pistol, gray tack? Why would you ever run anything else?
Why would you ever run anything else? Words of wisdom, folks. Words of wisdom. Now, if you've been following along all day, enjoying the emotes and doing Boogie Down, definitely come, you know, follow us. Follow these great people, Gubba TV, Pookie Face. They're on Twitch, they're streaming. You know, loving the game, playing Fortnite. You know, we're all loving Fortnite. You see the diverse group of people is really, really the coolest thing for me today was seeing the vast variety of people that all can enjoy Fortnite. Like, it's really just, it's inspiring to see. And with things that we have coming out, coming up soon, like Playground, and really to grow and expand that universe for what people can truly do in the game, I'm super excited.
Yeah, I had an opportunity earlier while I was watching the tournament to sit down and talk with Darren Sugg a little bit about everything, and that came up in conversation. I said it's interesting to me how Fortnite has actually transcended. It's ingrained itself in pop culture. It's broken social barriers between people, because what are you doing on the weekend, Mooney? Are you going to go home? You're just going to play Fortnite.
I'm going to play some Fortnite.
Right. So it's just very interesting to see a game take off like this and to just really be something that everybody can get into.
Right. And, you know, I, of course, a little light on the winds. I know I'm going to definitely lean on Gubba, Pookie, and Zeke to help me out here. But, you know, I like to think I can hold my own. I've been hanging around for a little bit. Gubba, what's... we got some action here. Gubba getting into a fight here. She's got multiple grenades going from the left. Leonidas taking her out. But you know what? You know what? You put up a great fight, Gubba. And, you know, any words?
They were going down. I just... They snuck up on me. I didn't know what was going on. Somebody came up out of nowhere.
A little bit of shock and awe there, shock and awe, folks. Happens to the best of us. But we're going to go ahead and hop into the next match here. And I'm gonna need to see some good squad strats this time. None of this, like, I'm going to drop in Lucky, I'm going to drop in Anarchy or something. But, Zeke, what are we going to do this game, Zeke? Give me a strategy call.
All right, here's what we're going to do, ladies and gentlemen, all right? We're going to hit it hard. We're going to hit it fast. We're going to go in. We're going to dive into Tilted. We're not actually diving. We're telling everyone to dive into Tilted Towers, okay? Wink, wink. We're going to Tilted Towers. Going to Tilted Towers, so everyone meet us there.
We're not going Tilted Towers.
We're going in hot.
We're going to be the first ones to land. We're
going
to get all the double pump action. Six damage all the way around. Traps, boom, left and right. They're not going to see it. It's going to happen so fast. Mooney, can you drop your character? We're going to go in. We're going to squad no fill. Because Mooney's going to be our casting man. Maybe he'll live up to Dr. Lupo and Golden Boy and Gloom. But we'll see what happens. But we're gonna do this fast. Gubba, do you want to talk a little bit about your strategy? Are you going to listen to us this time? Or
my strategy this time is we're going in hot. We're going in so hot, nobody's even going to see us coming.
I'm honestly going to see how much of this game I can play one-handed because I did not leave before we queued up. But I'm going to make a good effort of it. I think I can really pull this off. Maybe do a little bit of the microphone play strategies, but I got confidence in myself. You know, sure got, you know, a lot of confidence coming into this if I think I'm going to do this one-handed. But, you know, I can't say I've done anything more difficult at this point. But Battle Bus launching in 8. Were we actually dropping, Zeke?
Definitely
Tilted still.
Tilted Towers.
We're going to Tilted. Pookie, where are we going to drop?
I don't know. I thought the plan was to say go Tilted, but we're not going Tilted.
We're going Tilted.
Zeke seems to be confusing our teammates with his strategies here. We'll see if we can actually all land in the same place. Gubba, drop it early again. Gubba, I got you. Solidarity. I'm coming with you to Tilted. We're going Tilted. We're going Tilted. I got you, Gubba. Solidarity.
Oh, no.
Oh, look at this. Beautiful. We're going in hot for sure. All right, so we can drop in here, see if we can get some kills.
Big red. Go big red.
Go big red. Make it the call. Oh, there's a lot of people going to big red.
We're good.
trying at this point. We're going to see if I can grab some resources, maybe. Okay, gun. All right, sick. I got attack. An attack now. This is probably... You know, who said I can't multitask? Shout out to my math third grade math teacher who said I couldn't multitask. Look at me now, Mrs. Wong. Look at me now. I'm sorry, Mrs. Wong, but, you know, I'm killing it.
Game over, you guys. I just got blue tack.
Blue tack, over and out. That's what Gubba said. Now, Pookie, what's your strategy here picking up these weapons in Tilted?
I mean, at this point, I'm just looking for anything I can get, Uni.
Gubba needs back. I need backup. We both need backup. Down and out. Down and out. Can't actually multitask that well. Gonna recant that earlier statement to my math teacher. But.
Oh!
Is that Zeke picking up that early kill on Shroomy? Well done, my man. Nice.
It's gonna be okay.
Zeke coming in where I couldn't. The 11th hour. Gubba asked for the pickup.
I hit them first, so you basically just cleaned up right after me.
Yeah, she loosened the lid on the jar, Zeke. You just opened it. She loosened the lid on that slurp juice, lifted the lid off.
Oh, no!
We're down again. We got double down. Pookie, it's up to you. Can you do this? Hit him with a jump shot. Show these NBA players what's up. Hit him with that jump shot. Let's go. Pookie building that ramp, trying to get up, get some coverage, get some vantage points on him, shoot from up top. Dropping down. Nice. You got him. All right. At least we got one teammate to help us out and carry us through this. I got faith. I have belief. Thank you so much, Pookie.
Putting me under too much stress, Mooney.
I'm putting her under too much stress. That's on me. Zeke, anything to say about your performance at this point?
I saved Gubba. I saved POTUS. That's all that matters.
He saved Gubba, and he's keeping it. He's taking that W where he can. Gubba, any plans now that you've got your second lease on life?
I'm going to go win. This round is mine.
This round is hers, she said. No more getting caught off guard. No more having to weaken people. The eliminations are Gubba's, and the victory is all of ours. Because when one of us wins, we all win, right? Yeah, I'll be one of the people on the squad on your team. The other people obviously lose because, you know. Oh, chasing that VR, chasing that Victor Royale. Let's see if we can get there in the end. What is the strategy here, Pookie? What do you guys think you want to do here after you fully harvest from Tilted?
Well, I mean, you know, we don't even really know how many more people are left here, so it's just pretty much surviving and trying to get out of Tilted Towers as soon as possible.
Right, and I'm no math expert, but, you know, 48 people left, that's about a 50-50 shot at you. 47 is even better chances now. So, I'm pretty sure as the number goes down, your chances increase. If I'm good at math, and not sure at this point. But, you know, we're looking to see if they can clear up Tilted, get some more of that loot, honestly, do some remodeling, knock down some walls, knock down some towers, as they're all Tilted. I'm sorry for making that joke. So, Gubba, out of the weapons you have right now, which one are you going to lean on? Is it the blue tack or is it the white? Is it the pistol?
It's the gray pistol, obviously.
That gray pistol?
It's all I need, I'm that good.
It's all she needs, she's that good. Put away your tack shotguns. All right, Pookie, you wanna go ahead and tell us what happened there for you?
Diamond bullet killed me.
Diamond bullet really landing his shots. Well done, shout out to you at home. Another one bites the dust here. Oh, the tables have turned. Can Gubba get this kill here and help her teammates out? Oh yeah, using that favorite weapon. A little bit of a action going on, loosening that lid again, weakening that opponent. Oh, somebody coming in hot from the left too. We are just surrounded. Definitely a lot of people. Ooh, a little bit of assistance from above. Oh, Tango coming in to take us out, coming out of nowhere. Zeke, why don't you give us a rundown on positives, negatives from that match, what we could do better?
Okay, positives. Again, I saved Gubba, I saved POTUS, okay? She went down and I said, listen, I'll protect her. Jumped over, boom, shotgun to the face, down someone. Immediate elim, this was good. Started the res, I get downed. Pookie hops over, she's like, I'm gonna save them both. There's two ramps on our left. Pookie did not see them and was like, hey, where are they at? Almost died, that's cool, it's fine. It was very high adrenaline moment there. So, you know, maybe she was like, those are their ramps, it's fine. And then it just got worse and went downhill. We survived a long time though. She did. Mixed it with a great pistol. That was pretty awesome. All right, round three. Three. This is three. Second game. Third game. Round three.
All right, well, I'm actually going to host this one instead of having to do a little bit of multitasking, but we're going to hop in this next game, and I think I'm going to keep it to myself a little bit on where we might drop just to give everybody the chance to fully see if they can catch up to us, take us out with our new strategies. We're really feeling ourselves on this one. I think we can definitely pick up the win here. I got confidence in us. Okay, so we're gonna load in here. Gubba still rocking the no skin.
No skin all the way.
No skin, all the options. Rolling in this next match here. We're gonna try, and honestly, my goal for us as a team, and I'm just associating myself with you guys, even though I'm not at the skill level. Can we make it to top 20, guys? Top 20? Did we? Oh, okay. Hey, all right. Oh, that's right. We did have two kills. That's fair. All right, top 20. What do you think, Gubba?
Oh, heck yeah. We're going number one.
Heck yeah, number one. I like the confidence. Pookie, where you put us at for top 20?
I got to agree with Gubba. I think we take this one.
With Gubba, you think we take the other one? Hey, Zeke, I might have an inkling on what your answer might be, but what do you think? We think we take top 20 here?
Wait, what was it?
You think we're going to take top 20 here?
Yes. 100%.
Yes, 100%.
We're going to Anarchy Acres.
That's my home.
Okay, that's where we're going.
We're dropping at Gubba's house, Anarchy Acres. Going to Anarchy Acres. We're going to drop in here. We see, honestly, if we can get some kills. Tilted didn't work out for us. A little hectic. But if we can really perform at Anarchy, I think we can definitely overtake those who might harvest at Tilted, those who dare harvest at Tilted, so to speak. It is a dangerous place. I'm sorry, Gubba, what was that? We are on?
My turf, baby.
That's right, we're on Gubba's turf. You better watch out on that. I'm sorry, Pookie, do you have any commentary on your on Zeke's gameplay?
I mean, you know, he makes the call to drop Anarchy, and then I don't understand where he's gliding to. I'm very confused. It must be a high-level strat I'm just not aware of, Mooney.
Zeke employing some innovative high-level strategies, dropping away from his teammates. Zeke definitely just trying some out-of-the-box stuff here, folks. You're really seeing on-the-edge gameplay from Zeke. Thanks. Well done, Zeke. Any commentary on your gameplay, my friend?
I'm here. I just dropped really low. I made it, though. I'm in the building. It's okay.
I dropped. I'm here. I made it, though. Dropped. All of these are excuses to me. And Zeke's really going to pick up the slack to help out his teammates here. You know, Zeke, we can only help so much. All right, how are we looking on gear here? Ooh, I see you, Pookie. Just picking up that C4 off the bat?
I mean, they increased the range on it, so why not blow some stuff up? You know what I'm saying?
I got you. Trying to take down those structures. I see you keeping up on the changes. All right. Yeah, the mini shield running up on a treasure. Ooh, you know your locations, Gubba. This is your house.
This totally is my house. I grew up here.
This is Gubba's house. She actually grew up here. Born and raised in Anarchy Acres and really just living the Anarchy life. No rules, all Gubba. That's the saying. That's what they say. People say that.
That is what they say.
They say that, confirmed. All right, so Pookie, do we really think Zeke is going to be able to make up for his, you know, weird calls at the beginning of this match?
I mean, say what you want about Zeke, but the guy's got heart. You know what I'm saying? You can't question that about him. Skill level aside, he's got heart.
Skill level aside, Zeke has heart, ladies and gentlemen. So I think that's a sentiment we can all really grab onto, having heart in the absence of skill. Zeke, any comments?
I'm really good at the game.
So we're gonna have to see if the kills can actually speak for himself. The elimination can speak for himself. Zeke gotta try and come in here, try and pick up some eliminations, really prove himself to his team. Is he gonna be able to prove it out? Is he gonna do it? He's definitely got some big shoes to fill. I'm not sure what size shoes Gubba and Pookie fill, but Zeke definitely looking like a small one right now, looking like a small shoe size. You have to fill those up. I don't know where I'm going with this metaphor, but it's somewhere. And still in Anarchy Acres, definitely trying to clear this out. What are your guys' plans? You're pretty far from the circle now.
Oh, you know, loot around, do some dancing, and then roll on down probably.
Nice. hang around, do some dances, roll on downwind, super casual, super laid back. Just gonna roll right in, finish him off. I got it. This is good, rolling up here. Pookie, what is your favorite outfit?
Favorite outfit? I think Bright Bomber. It's very colorful, the hair is good. You got the unicorn llama.
Nice, Bright Bomber, hair is good. Looking good, feeling good. You know, and in all honesty, it has been a good one. Oh, I'm joined on the couch here. What's up? You want to go ahead and introduce yourself to all of our fans out here?
How you doing? I'm Tariq Cohen, running back for the Chicago Bears.
That's awesome, Tariq. How have you been joining the Pro-Am so far, my man?
Oh, I'm loving it. You know, Fortnite is a game that I love. I feel like it's one of the best games ever made. You know, it's doing record-breaking numbers. And I'm really, you know, thankful for Epic Games for bringing me out here.
Appreciate it, man. No, thank you for coming out. It has been an exciting day. It has been some hot stuff, hot plays happening out there. So, who you giving play the game for the Pro-Am today?
I would have to say, I'm going to go with the usual answer, Ninja. He just clutches two dubs. He had 2v1 when he had two people. He made that happen.
Ninja definitely coming in with a clutch, and I think a lot of people were hoping to see that. Like, talking to the fans, talking to the predictions, a lot of people calling out that Ninja stuff. But a lot of folks surprising us out there today.
Taga, when he first killed Ninja in that first game, I think everybody was like, oh, this dude's real right here.
Oh, yeah, no, shout out to all the Gotaga fans out there. Like, he was definitely holding his own, and that first match was hype. I could hear multiple places, hear the audience, hear the crowd. It was popping off. All right. We got Tariq, we got you in this match here. What's your favorite outfit? You rock your favorite outfit here?
Oh, yeah, this is the only one I don't have back at home, because this one haven't came back out since it came out the first time. So it's like dream come true to use it.
Yeah, there you go, man. All right, so do you have a specific strategy? Is there a place you like dropping, anything like that?
My first game on, I always like to, you know, drop tilted, a hot spot, get my feet wet.
Right, got to drop in the hot spot, get your feet wet, see what you're working with, really, right? You got to drop in there. Any favorite weapons, items that you try to go for first?
Any shotgun, that's what I go for first. And then the preferred shotgun is the blue pump.
Nice, so a blue pump man. I see. All right, well, we're gonna have to see if you can pick up a couple of kills in this game, eliminations in the game, pick up that win. It's gonna be good. Now Pookie, you guys seem to be getting to top 30. This is looking good. You guys are getting close here to 20. Any specific strategy you've been trying to employ now?
I mean, I think we're just trying to avoid any kind of confrontation. I think if we just lay low, play it smart, run the edge of the circle, you should be able to place pretty high.
Right, and with Zeke on your team, I definitely understand wanting to lay low. Really can't trust his combat prowess, and at this point, we really don't know what we're working with. Is that true, Zeke?
Mooney, you saw my pin, my enamel Fortnite pin. You know how good I am at this game.
That's true. I have been being a little disingenuous. Zeke is pretty good at this game. Tariq got some action here. Got hit by one. All right, man. Yeah, quick game there. So you warm up with a tilted. You try to get an understanding where you're going to go, what you're going to be at. What are we thinking this next game? Where are we going to drop here?
Same thing. I'm dropping tilted because these games really just for fun. You can't hear where people are, so you just got to go. I'm going to go to tilted where I know it's going to be people, and I just got to, you know, be on my P's and Q's.
For sure, and it's like, fool me once, shame on you. Fool me twice, I kill you, eliminate you, now you tilted, right? Take him to tower and tilt him. That's true. All right, that's good. Warming up into this next match with Tariq. And my homies on the couch making it almost to top 20. We're at 26 left right now. Very proud of you guys. Good job, Gubba. So how have you been carrying this team?
Well, I got an extra large backpack, you know, so I was able to really carry them, and we're going backpacking, so good time.
You see, the trick is, folks, the biggest backpack of all is no backpack with the nose skin, you know? I see you, Gubba. All right, I see you. I understand. Now, Zeke, really looking for you here to make some moves. I've been talking you up here for the last, like, 15 seconds at least, if not 30. We're going to have to see if you can do some building, quick building here. Tariq getting ready to drop into this next game. All right, man, what is your favorite emote?
Probably this one right here. It's the shoot dance that Blockboy JB made up, though.
Nice, you got to talk about that hype emote? Nice, yeah, like hype, that's good, man. Oh. Nice, all right, so in retail this time, any specific strategy you got when you're dropping into retail? Do you like to hit the outside first, work yourself inside?
The stores. I had the black tops first, and then I worked down to the houses.
Nice, very smart move. You know, Retail Row, definitely good to hit the stores in Retail Row. Pick up all those purchases fresh as you can. Oh, ooh, oh, hold up. We may have missed a kill here. Gubba picking up a kill. Ooh, all right, Bubba. Is that her? All right, you know, Zeke. Oh, Zeke picked, okay, Zeke picked up one too. All right, I stand corrected. I was definitely gonna throw some shade. I stand corrected. All right, Zeke.
I'm still carrying.
You hear that? Zeke, you better get another
all
one.
Right, all right.
She has got you in that North Face, and she has no thoughts of putting you down. Pookie, what do we got here? How you gonna work the circle?
I mean, I'm just trying to get it. I don't even know, Mooney. We don't even have a strat. The best strat is no strat.
The best strat is no strat. A potentially controversial strategy in and of itself. Yeah, Tariq, I see you picked up a couple of weapons here off the bat. Maybe some action.
Are those two people up there?
No. Whew. All right.
Lit him up real quick. He didn't even know he was there.
Didn't know he was there and gets a legendary and a porta fort out of that? That's a good deal.
Appreciate it. I'm going to tell him thank you while he's in the lobby.
Hey, thank you. Thank you from Tariq. Tariq says thank you. Shout out to you at home. And we're going to be rolling. We got a legendary heavy.
Around right now because I can't hear anything, so I just got to keep my eyes peeled.
Keep your eyes peeled. We're going to see if we can find any folks running around.
I'd like to point out that we're top 20, so.
Okay. All right. They made it top 20, but this is where things get spicy. You make it to top 20. Let's see that victory. You guys were claiming, we're going to get the victory. It's going to roll in. It's going to be no big deal.
No.
Is that actually? Ooh, all right. Tariq back in some action here. Is he going to be able to pull this off? Definitely some exciting battles going on underneath the stairs. And the stair combat, pretty close quarters. To be completely honest.
Can't hear anything. Oh, somebody right there.
Oh! Ooh, Stumbye coming in with that quick shot. Coming about a quick shot. In all honesty, I trust our team to get the victory because at this point we've kind of circled in. We've gotten our loot from Anarchy, got a lot of this stuff. Zeke, do you really think you guys can pull this out? What's your level of confidence here? What percentage chance are you gonna give me?
It's like a 50-50, Mooney. I'm going to give it everything I've got, and I'm going to make sure that they feel my wrath here right now.
50-50, going to hope that they can feel his wrath. Interesting. Now, Pookie, you got yourself some solid resources. Oh, here we go.
Get him.
Pookie, what could you have done there to maybe pull that out for the squad?
I mean, I tried pushing the guy. I thought I knew where he was. He had the pump. He won pumpy. That's the way it goes sometimes.
Zeke, why don't you go run us through that game? What happened? Experiences? How you feel?
That was a really fun game. Obviously, playing with Gubba and Pookie Face, super fun. There's a lot of things that went really wrong, but a lot of things that went really right. We actually killed those guys up on the middle spire. Gubba's carrying, even though she's like never with us, but it's all good. But ladies and gentlemen, we want to thank you guys so much for tuning in to the Pro-Am. You guys have been absolutely amazing. The support and love that you guys have showed us is just incredible. Thank you guys so much. We hope you enjoyed it. Had a ton of fun, because we definitely did. Thank you guys so much. Congratulations to the victors. Congratulations to all the charities. This is what we do. You know, we're here to have fun, and we hope that you did too. So thank you guys so much for tuning in. We'll see you guys on the Battle Bus. Moon, you want to say goodbye real fast?
Yeah, sure.
You know what? It's been a great one. Enjoyed all of it. Thank you to all of you for watching and participating. Fortnite's amazing. We can't wait to see what happens in the future with all of you. Thanks so much.